Scott Nelson has the choice of an orange or a lemon lime Gatorade. He has selected lemon lime. So I will get the orange tonight.
Go with the old staple.
Good job. We are online, so right. Say hello to everybody.
Hello, everybody. Say goodnight, Gracie.
Good night, Gracie. Okay. This is Jay's mic, play-by-play, test, test, test. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Test, 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 test.
All right, Scott. Here's Scott. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Test. Thank you.
I can't believe they keep letting us do this.
Isn't it great?
Yep.
What a beautiful night.
Great country.
Yep.
Man.
71.
This is awesome.
Thunderstorms possible at 12:45.
Perfect.
Winds north at 6. Two minutes.
By that time, I will be head on a pillow. It's raining.
Yeah, probably. Huh? Just like last week. Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, will you please stand, remove your hats, as Chloe Cole will sing our national anthem.
All right, here comes the anthem. One minute. Boy, it's going to be close. Seconds. Okay. 10 seconds. Join in progress. 5, 4, 3. From Brighton Box Stadium in Middleton, it's time for the Prep Mania Game of the Week on TVW and Channel3000.com. Tonight, the Big 8 Conference battle between the Sun Prairie Cardinals and the Middleton Cardinals. Hi, everybody. Scott Nelson, Jay Wilson with you as we get ready for Week 2 of the 2016 high school football season. And Scott, both of these teams had convincing wins last week as Middleton defeated Madison Memorial 31-3 at Mansfield Stadium. And Sun Prairie was a 34-7 winner over Madison East. Both of those games were shortened by weather issues last week. And so in a lot of ways, we're still going to trying to find out how good these teams really are. And, boy, tonight's the test for both of them.
Yeah, I think the matchup last week, Jay, with Middleton and Memorial, I think was kind of more of the marquee because Middleton lost to Memorial last year. And so here's a chance for them to stake claim on and stay in contention and get after things here right away with a 1-0 start. That's exactly what they did. Great defense, solid. Guys are aggressive across the board. When I watch film with some Prairie and East, again, a very aggressive defense. I think you got two really good defensive squads going at each other tonight. The difference maker might be that offensive line for Middleton here tonight. They're big, they're strong, and how long can that front seven for some Prairie hold up against them?
Yeah, for Middleton, that offensive line. Among the players we'll be keeping an eye on tonight, number 76 is Caden Lyles, 6'3", 320 pounds. He's the guy that came from Arizona. He's a University of Wisconsin Badger recruit. His brother, Kare, is a quarterback on the Badger roster right now. But Lyles and Jared Horst and Dadrian Spears and Justin Sarbacher and Seth Craker, they're the guys that can open some holes for that Middleton offensive line. So it'll be a big test for the Sun Prairie defensive line to keep things in check. There you see Middleton's Joe Polisek. He's getting ready to kick off as the Cardinals will be receiving. Well, I could say Cardinals and not be wrong tonight,
yeah.
Can I?
You know, the one thing that when you mention all those big names, big bodies, they're still 16, 17, 18-year-old kids. It doesn't matter who you're playing. You get a little momentum going, and those emotions start into play. Who can keep those in check tonight might be the difference maker.
Both teams 1-0. Let's see who's going to move on to the top of the Big 8 Conference and stay there through week two. Polisek waiting for the signal from the officials. He makes his run. There's the swing, and it's a high floating kick that carries down to about the 7-yard line, taken there by Nathan Coy for Sun Prairie, and he's out past the 30-yard line. So Sun Prairie with a pretty good starting position for their first possession.
Real good field position for Sun Prairie, and here comes that defense for Middleton after the return. Ludwig is a guy that I think you got to keep your eye on. Joe Ludwig, number 19, moves down to linebacking position from defensive back. And C.J. Furmanek is a guy that you will hear from Middleton time and time again. Quarterback, returner, defensive back, very athletic out on the field.
Jalen Taylor starts at running back for Sun Prairie. The quarterback starting tonight is Jack Zander, 6'3", 200-pound junior. He hands to Taylor, who had 5 touchdowns, tying a school record last week against Madison East, and his first carry results in about 3.5 inches.
And this is kind of the feeling out process right now for that front seven from Middleton, that offensive line for Sun Prairie. Body on a body. Seams aren't going to be as big as they were last week for both teams. Middleton plays really good defense up front, square shoulders. They plug holes. He just needs a little seam to squirt through.
One more time to Taylor. Tries to make a shifty move, but he runs into a lot of red-shirted Middleton Cardinals, and it's going to be third and very long for Sun Prairie as the first two runs lose a yard.
So here's what I see when you watch defensively. You got two defenses that like to blitz, get after each other. They'll come off the edge. They'll come up the middle. Two plays in a row, Middleton's done a really good job on their play calling and plugging the hole, making sure that they got a linebacker flowing free to make the tackle.
Let's see if Zander puts it up for the first time tonight. He does, throwing and in and out of the hands of Walker Jenkins, who is coming on a crossing pattern. Like another shot at that one. Incomplete. Fourth down, 3 and out for Sun Prairie.
Good trail position by the defensive back. That's probably a 5-6 yard reception at best. And then he turns upfield. I'm not sure with the way the defensive back is playing on the back hit if he would have made the first down on that throw anyways.
Alex Oakley into kick. There you see Oakley. 6'3", 200-pound junior. Back to return for Middleton, Trey Turner and C.J. Furmanek. Here's Oakley. Floater toward Furmanek, and he's going to return it. Well, I think some of the Sun Prairie return people thought he was going to fair catch that, but Furmanek is one of the best return men in the conference. Gets a nice run back there, and it'll be Middleton starting out in Sun Prairie territory with their first possession.
Punt returning is always hard because your eyes are up for so long. You don't know where defenders are coming and screaming down the field. He caught the ball, a quick glance. He saw a little seam off to the outside. Boom, off he goes. He gets a nice 10-yard gain. on the return. Really good job. Three and out defensively. We'll see what they can do now here on offense.
Tim Simons in his 13th year as head coach of Middleton. 95 wins, 32 losses. Okay, here's the Middleton offense. Our first look at that. Furmanek calling the signals. He's rolling right. Gets a good block from his running back and throws it up in the air. And Nathan Coy, oh boy, he almost had an interception on the first play of the game. They were looking for Myron Ashford. Incomplete, and Coy had two hands on it, and he usually makes that catch.
Really good jam on Ashford at the line of scrimmage by number 21. Marty Stry, an outside linebacker, almost knocked him down to the ground. And that's when, as Nathan Coy, a senior defensive back, has to go up strong, can't relax like he did there. You got to go after that football with purpose. He brings that down for a pick. Instead, he kind of gets a little lazy with his hands, and he drops the football.
Deion Huff was the featured running back for Middleton last week. 108 yards and two touchdowns. He's the lone setback behind Furmanek. And here's the first carry of the game for Huff. And he runs into the right side of the line, and not much doing there. He did get about three, I guess, down to the 45.
Trying to run over big Caden Lyles off the right side there. Nice job walling down, but that backside for some Prairie's defense, good job again. Two defense to keep their shoulders squared, plugging gaps, getting down there and walling it down. So the backside played patient, a little slow played it. They were able to come from the backside. Marty Stry wrapping them up first in the back end.
Noah Hellbach is the fullback for Middleton. The receivers, Jack Tenius, 83, Myron Ashford, 18. They are split wide. Now in motion goes Hellbach. Handoff. Huff slips two tackles. Almost slipped a third, but that's going to be enough for a Middleton first down. Third and seven, and they convert.
I don't know if we'll get a chance to see the replay or not, but 86, Ethan Ackley, and 88, Josh Dinga coming off the left side of that defensive line. I think it was Ackley who got his hand on the running back to begin with. Just didn't shed the block enough, slowed him down, but that pursuit has to continue to come. And you got a talented, shifty running back in the back edge there. He's a guy that's going to break those tackles. Strong, low center of gravity, and made the most of it.
Outside linebacker Zach Parrish made the stop, but not before Huff got a first down for Middleton. They're at the 38-yard line. Early first quarter, no score. A handoff again to Huff. And he squirts ahead for about five.
I like watching him run. Listed only at 5'6 and 180 pounds. Again, a low center of gravity, good pad level. What I mean by that is he's got him tilted forward a little bit. He's not running up and down where the front of the shoulder pads are exposed. It's the top of the shoulder pad. So when he takes a hit, he's also delivering a punch on the back edge as well, and that's why he continues to drive forward for extra yards.
Marty Stry, who led Sun Prairie in tackles against East last week with seven, he made that tackle, but now they're marching off a penalty against Middleton. So that'll force the Cardinals back to the 45-yard line. So our first penalty of the evening goes against Middleton. And a first and 15 coming up from the 43. Furmanek out of the shotgun. And Myron Ashford jumped the snap count, so that's going to be 5 yards against Middleton. And Tim Simon not very pleased with that. He tells Cole Ragsdale to get in there for Ashford, and he's going to have a talk with the senior wide receiver.
That's a very nice way of putting that.
I try to be supportive, Scott.
Yeah, and you need to be. And that, you know, so when you watch this stuff, those foolish penalties are what kill the coach, especially out on the edge as a wide receiver. There's no point in you jumping the snap at all. You just sit there, wait till the ball goes, and now you're sitting at first and forever, first and 20. But that's a tough way to go when you had a little drive and a little momentum going offensively.
First and 20, play action. Furmanek in trouble, escapes the rush initially. Now he comes to the near sideline. He's going to be tackled by Stry, but it's a pretty good gain where Furmanek got some pretty good pressure, and it'll be second and about, looks like about 15 for Middleton.
He got back that 5 yards that they lost on that false start. Furmanek again, shifty. He's not afraid to get Tuckett and run. He's athletic. He might not be a great quarterback, but he's a great athlete, and he can make things happen in the back edge. A really good job outside on the edge by Marty Stry, shedding the block and keeping him to the outside, getting low into his legs.
Furmanek ran a 4.59 40 at the WFCA combine in May, so he's got some pretty good speed, and he's got a lot of great common sense athletically. And off to Huff, and not much doing there. As number 40, Will Van Peterson leads the charge for the Sun Prairie defense. Third and long for Middleton coming up.
Van Peterson, when you look at him, 5'10", 185 pounds. Not a real big linebacker, but he's a guy that plays with a lot of heart, a lot of energy. He gets in the mix with Zach Parrish. You get in the mix with Ben Hauser, with Marty Stry. Those linebackers, if they're allowed to flow, are athletic and strong, and they'll pack a punch when they hit you.
Third and 13, Middleton at the 41-yard line. Last week, Firmenich was 5 of 11 for 78 yards and an interception. Looks to throw this time. Swings it out from Hellbach. In and out of his hands and nearly intercepted. Or did he? Marty Stry making the play for Sun Prairie.
I think Stry knocked the ball out, Jay, but I think the ball did hit the turf. A really good job reading, getting back into your curl, the flat zone.
Wow.
Recognizing the ball, floated a little bit, timed it perfectly, and separating the receiver from the football. Great job. Really good series by Marty Stry.
Oh, he hit Hellbach between the 4 and the 9. What a play. Boy, Strysman. That's a good series for Marty Stry, isn't it? Fourth and 13, Middleton. Firmenich to punt. Goes toward the far side, and a fair catch made at the 8-yard line by Coy, so that's where Sun Prairie gets it. Both teams punt to end their first possessions of our game.
Two pretty good defensive series by both sides here tonight. A great crowd that we got. You can tell they're energetic. Student sections are dressed up. I think Middleton's in Hawaii. Sun Prairie is what they call their frat night, so they're all dressed up in Oxfords, having some fun with all this stuff and enjoying so far here in the first 5 minutes of the game some pretty darn good football.
Brian Kaminsky in his 14th season as Sun Prairie's head coach, played football at UW-Whitewater. 97 wins, 43 losses, so both of our coaches closing in on their 100th career coaching victories. They'll get them at some point this year. Now here comes Sun Prairie, and they hit it a long one. As Xander lays out to Coy perfectly for a big gain.
Well, you drop an interception in the first play from scrimmage. Defensively, you come back, you run a great little double route, slant in, get upfield. You got a defender on your backside, and a great job by Xander floating that ball out there up and over the top. He's one step away from taking the distance.
Boy, Xander threw that beautifully, and Coy just burned that secondary. That was a 35-yard completion to Coy.
And they come back with just a quick power game with number 20, Jalen Taylor. Again, the workhorse last week with Draven Peoples being down. And they gained 6 yards on the play. Nice seam right up the gut.
Peoples with an ankle injury. We thought we were going to see him tonight, but weren't 100% sure. So far, it's been all Jalen Taylor. Now here's Xander faking to Taylor and keeps it. And he's fortunate to get maybe a yard or two.
And I think Xander was thinking Taylor was going to take the football from him. He never did. Thankfully, he didn't let go of it for the Cardinals of Sun Prairie. Smart play by your quarterback. You know where the play is going. Tuck in behind your running back and use him as an extra blocker if need be. They gain an extra yard out of a busted play.
DeMarcos Deloney is the fullback, 43. He's 5'10", 245. Xander now looks over to the sidelines for a little more direction. Taylor is the running back to his right. Now Taylor shifts over to the quarterback's left, and timeouts on Prairie. Yeah, things were just a little bit out of whack there, so Brian Kaminsky will take a timeout.
Watching their sideline, Jay, you see the coaches out trying to get a little bit more visible. And so the players, looks like what they're doing is they're getting set up. They're calling some plays maybe at the line of scrimmage, and then they're checking the defensive front. Probably communicating to the coaches upstairs here in the box. And then I watched a couple of the coaches. They're doing more signals. So they must have something worked out here tonight where, hey, we'll see what they set up in first defensive, and we'll try and counteract that with a play based on what they saw on scout film. And didn't like what they saw all the way across the board, so they called timeout. Smart play.
These are, of course, two great rivals in any sport, really, Sun Prairie and Middleton. And I think you touched on it earlier, Scott, the wacky series they had last year. In the regular season, Middleton defeated Sun Prairie 45-13 in a game we did. And then come the playoffs, first round of the playoffs, Sun Prairie came to Middleton and won 30-23. So that can only stoke the fires of this great rivalry for the guys that have played in those games last year. Now here's Xander Third down, another fly floater that he tried to hit Walker Jenkins, but just a little too far. Furmanek on the coverage for Sun Prairie, and also Jack Smith was coming over to help from his safety spot. So that'll force fourth and three for Sun Prairie.
Just a timing route. Walker Jenkins doing a five-yard out. If he doesn't get it, he turns upfield, basically a chair route at that point. Xander just floated a little bit too far. Walker had some time behind the defensive back. Safety was late coming over. It's 3 yards shorter. Walker completes that for the first down. Missed opportunity there for Sun Prairie.
C.J. Furmanek, first-team all-conference punt returner last year. He's deep. He's at about his 12-yard line along with Trey Turner. Oh, and they're going to fake it as Oakley tries to throw a pass over the head of Caden White. So a little chicanery by Brian Kaminsky. Comes up empty, though, and Middleton will take over at midfield.
Well coached by Middleton on this side. Communication down the line, watching the fake. They got up, good hard press, and then they just sat and waited. Expecting something at midfield, fourth and short. Not a bad place to try that for Sun Prairie. Again, just a little bit overthrown. One time from your quarterback on third down, this time from your punter on fourth and short. Trusting that defense with what they saw that last series, can they bow up and do it again?
Max Elliott on the coverage of White, incomplete. Ball turned over on downs. First and 10 at the 50 for Middleton. Still looking for our first score with just over 5 minutes left. Oh, looked like somebody jumped, no flag. Now here's Huff escaping one tackle, bouncing outside. Another stiff arm escapes the tackle, and Huff with a big run. He stepped out of bounds at the 18-yard line. Well, I don't know if that's just hard running or sloppy tackling, but it's a big gain for Huff.
Well, great job walling down the left side of that offensive line first and then tiptoeing down the sideline for Huff. Really good job, but I think you called at the beginning. I think Furmanek, right before he got the ball, flinched a little bit, and the officials didn't call that. And I watched the coaches on Sun Prairie side. They were really frustrated that a flag wasn't thrown, but defensively, you can't. If you're pointing and you're calling for a flag, you better get yourself ready to play yet because big plays like that happen.
32-yard gain for Huff. He'll take a rest, and James Pabst, who had a good week last week, he's in now, the running back behind Furmanek. And Pabst will get the carry, and he's met at the 15.
You talk about Pabst and Huff both last week, both over 100 yards, both got into the end zone. So you have 1-2 punch with a couple guys that are strong, shifty. Again, not real tall and big, but guys that will make you miss have some speed, as we saw from Huff earlier.
Zach Parrish leading the way for the Sun Prairie defense on that stop. Gain of two, they're going to call it. Ball at the 16-yard line, second and 8, Middleton. Pabst again. Oh, he barely got back to the line of scrimmage.
If we get a shot at this replay, I talked about Middleton coming from a lot of different angles. Sun Prairie coming from a lot of different angles. Ben Hauser showed like he was going to blitz, backed off at the snap of the ball, straight line right through the A-gap, first contact made on the running back. Really good job by the senior linebacker, who they weren't sure was going to be able to play this year. So, boy, he brings a nice anchor to that defense as a senior who's got a lot of experience playing all-conference player last year for Sun Prairie.
Hauser hurt his elbow playing baseball, and, yeah, they didn't know if they'd have him at all this year. All of a sudden, they can delay a surgery until after the season, and he's all set for a full year of football. It's a completed pass to Ashford. Not a little crossing pattern, and good throw by Furmanek, and it looks like it's going to be a first down for Middleton, first and goal. So they convert on third and 8.
Good job by Ashford on the slant, and a slip by Nathan Coyett on the edge. He read it. He was coming right to the point of attack where the ball is going to meet the receiver, but because of the slip, he's a step late, half step late, and it results in a big reception and a first and goal.
And Furmanek stood in there as he was taking a lick, but completed the pass to Ashford. First and goal, Middleton at the 7.
See Hauser in your screen with his left elbow in a brace.
Mm-hmm. But they say he can't hurt it more, so he's okay. Here's Huff exploding through a hole on the right side, getting down to the 3.
Bringing in a couple different personnel, maybe goal line. They got Joe Ludwig coming in, another big body. We talked about him. He's a 212-pound, what they term, running back. I think they use him in a lot of different places. Certainly linebacker is where he's made his name here for the Cardinals of Middleton.
Ethan Ackley with the tackle for Sun Prairie on that last play. Second and goal from the four after a three-yard pickup by Huff. Oh, there's a lot of beef in that backfield in there. They'll pitch it to Huff going right side, and he's tripped up in the backfield. That was Will Van Petersen exploding through for a loss.
Two names we've called an awful lot. Van Petersen, one, number 21, Marty Stry. Stry comes up on the right edge of that offensive line, holds the corner, got upfield, and engaged in a block and forced your running back to come underneath. That's where Van Petersen slips, makes a play. C21, hold the edge, forced him back in. Van Petersen doesn't tackle him, but he gets into his legs and he trips him up.
Joe Ludwig in the backfield helping to block there, but Van Petersen beat him both. One more time for Huff. Boy, those are some tough yards in there, aren't they? 86, Ethan Ackley again on the stop for Sun Prairie, so not much there. It's going to be third down, or make it fourth down, and goal from the five, so a field goal coming up as Joe Polacek comes in.
I would imagine storylines in the coaching staffs and in the locker rooms. Middleton is thinking, hey, Sun Prairie knocked us out of the playoffs. We beat them. Let's get after them here tonight. The other side, hey, there's some big offensive line. People don't think you can hold up against them. Sun Prairie, what are you going to do? And so far they've held up well on that front with the field goal being good.
Polacek from 22. And Middleton's on the board, 3-0.
That defensively for Sun Prairie is a great stand. You give them field position inside your own 50. You give up a couple big plays, nice reception in the long run. But you tightened up when you needed to inside that 5-yard line to hold them to 3 points. That's something you can build on here the rest of the game.
So Joe Polacek, who kicked a field goal last week, gets one this week. And Middleton leading at home 3-0. Around the Big Eight last night, they played a game at Three Stevens Field. There's a music concert, festival there tonight and tomorrow night. So they played Thursday night at Three Stevens. Janesville Craig beat East 57-38. So Craig now 1-1 in the season. East goes to 0-2. The other games tonight in the Big Eight, Madison Memorial at Madison West, Madison La Follette at Janesville Parker, and Beloit Memorial visits Verona.
I think Janesville Craig, just hearing that score, has probably scored 100 points in the first two games. They're darn close to it.
Yeah.
And they're 1-1. That's amazing.
Yeah.
Last week they lost to La Follette in a big shootout, if I'm not mistaken, and come back with Madison East last night and run it up again.
Yeah. Polacek to kick it off. High floater to about the 7-yard line. And here comes that running back, Jalen Taylor, and he has a nice burst out past the 30-yard line.
And Nathan Coy, another deep back there, but you're up. You have Taylor at the deep receiver. You got to make sure you're talking loud, calling those guys off. They got to get upfield and block for you, but smart that he was able to catch the football. No fumble, no miss, muff return there. But he gets up, gets some good yards, and Coy has to realize if that's floating over my head, if I go backwards, let the guy behind me get it, get up and engage in a block.
First and 10 at the 31. The receiver to the far side for Sun Prairie, Cooper Nelson, number 85. This is a running play, though. And Peoples in there for the first time, Draven Peoples, who started the game last week against East, hurt his ankle. That opened the door for Jalen Taylor for his 5 touchdowns, but now Peoples makes his first appearance with a little over a minute left in the first quarter.
Peoples brings a little bit more size between him and Taylor. Shifty, quick running backs, but more size and power out of Peoples if his ankle can hold up.
Peoples again gets past Ludwig. Well, Ludwig with nice pursuit. Boy, looked like the ball popped out, but I think they said he was down, and it's going to be third and about maybe 2 for Sun Prairie as Peoples got it to the 40-yard line.
Sun Prairie's going a little bit more hurry up, trying to prevent personnel changes and get the defense back on their heels, not knowing what's happening.
Peoples again. Well, he bounced off the initial hit, and that's going to be a first down for Sun Prairie.
There you see the power out of Peoples, the leg drive, the strength, getting his low shoulder pads and pushing behind that offensive line, knowing what you need. Last year, when I watched Peoples in this game against Middleton, when we called that in the rain, the second half, he went off. He had a lot of big gains and kind of burst on the scene as a sophomore. I'm sure they've game planned a little bit more knowing the type of player that he is.
Nearing the end of the first quarter, play action. That's Nathan Florek in, and he throws a bomb to Walker Jenkins, and Jenkins is going to score. Well, Nathan Florek had this series at quarterback for Sun Prairie, and he hit Walker Jenkins in stride, and it's a 56-yard scoring pass, and Sun Prairie takes the lead.
Well, I think what they saw when they had Nathan Coy up over the top, they think with their receivers. Now, Sun Prairie's thinking they can get up and over the top. They run a little play action. They've seen the corners for Middleton bite on the double route. They've seen them get a little flat-footed at times, not where they're not moving, but they're trying to jump a route. Well, you run a little double move again. Now, this time, Walker Jenkins gets up and over the top. They connect Nathan, or Jack Zander missed deep on the one open over the top with Walker Jenkins before. This time Nathan Fleurick comes in, the senior quarterback, and connects with the extra point going through right at the end of the first quarter. I got a little feeling here that this is going to be a nice defensive battle with some big offensive plays because the hard yards are going to be hard.
Boy, Jenkins just blew by the Middleton defenders. I tell you what, all I heard was, oh, Sun Prairie doesn't know who their quarterback's going to be. But tell you what, Florick put that one right on the money, and Zander put one on the money, too. And
both those guys have thrown a nice deep ball. Yep, if that offensive line can hold up long enough up front to give those guys time to clear in routes, get in a cross run, get deep like we've seen a couple times, if they can hold up long enough, I think they're seeing that some of the speed and the matchups that they have favor the Sun Prairie Cardinals. Now, can they hold up in front there that long every single time? I got a feeling Middleton will dial up some pressure and get after him next time, but both quarterbacks so far have shown they can throw a really good deep ball.
So after Middleton gets a field goal, it's Florick to Jenkins for 56 and a touchdown. 7-3 Sun Prairie as Alex Oakley made the extra point, and now Oakley will kick. And Middleton trailing for the first time. This is a spinner that goes to Firmenich at the 5. Patiently looks for a hole, now cuts it upfield. And Firmenich got it out to the 30. Good coverage there by 29, Miguel Chestnut for Sun Prairie. We've seen Firmenich play defense. We've seen him play quarterback. We've seen him return kicks. I'm going to have a question for you when we come back. End of the first quarter, Sun Prairie 3-7, Middleton 3. We'll be back to Middleton in a moment. You're watching the Prep Mania Game of the Week on DBW and Channel3000.com.
Yeah. I tell you.
What's that?
Hey.
Right.
He brought everybody over.
Yeah, it was great. Nice job.
Yeah, great camera. Nice keep it
up. 30 seconds. So Middleton has it.
Yeah, the 30-yard line.
And this is the quarter.
Yep.
Fifteen seconds. Ten. Five, four, three. Here's our only touchdown of the game. Nathan Florek of Sun Prairie on his first series tonight. He lets it fly, and Walker Jenkins runs right under it. 7-3 our score as Middleton starts out first and 10 at their own 30, and the running play, that's going to be a loss of about a half a yard. Firmenich held onto it and couldn't get much out of it.
Good pressure, good surge up front. Sun Prairie likes to run a 3-5 defense, so they let their linebackers flow. So you have three down linemen usually head up around the A-gap with the center. A couple guys will shift around between guard tackle, and you're never sure where those linebackers are coming from. If you allow them to flow, they're an aggressive group that will come at you, much like Middleton has on their linebacking court. Guys that will come, like to hit in this game.
They'll call it no gain for Firmenich, second and 10. He's going deep, looking for Ashford, jump ball, and incomplete. Caden Koppinen was defending. Ball was batted up in the air, and neither Ashford nor Koppinen could get it.
Well, Kalpanen does a good job of recovering on an underthrown football. This gets up and over the top. He got caught again on a little double move, gets spun around, comes back inside. And again, if that's thrown a little bit deeper, just a little bit underthrown, and I think you're looking at Ashford certainly trying to wind his way down the field for 6 points. But a big break for the Sun Prairie Cardinals and one missed opportunity for Middleton.
Third and 10, balls at the Middleton 30, just underway second quarter. Furmanek to throw. He'll drop it off to the running back. And that's going to be well short of the first down as James Papps was in. He took the little swing pass, went to the far sideline, but defended well by Sun Prairie, fourth down.
Trying to give similar looks, similar routes to that defensive backs, to the linebackers. They just leak a receiver. Basically, you're running back out of the backfield and try and catch those guys turning to run deep. Nice play call, but a real good read and reaction by the outside guys, Will Van Peterson. Again, another play that he's been involved in, just trusting what he's seeing, going after it and making plays.
Now, Pabst a little late getting out of the field for the punt coverage. Looks like he'll get there in time. They're okay on the play clock, so Furmanek back to punt from his own 20. And this is a high, short, wobbly kick. Let's see the bounce. Well, that's a good Middleton bounce to the 30. And finally down at about the 23 as Caleb Simbalak was there to down it for Middleton. So Sun Prairie, which got a 56-yard touchdown pass its last possession, now gets the ball back at their own 28. I was going to ask you about C.J. Furmanek. Okay, yep. We've seen him punt, we've seen him return, we've seen him quarterback, we've seen him cornerback.
Probably water boy. I don't know. What I mean, else he can do?
How hard is that?
You know, I think for a kid, when you look at it, you're a senior. You've been around it. You've been involved in a lot of different aspects of the game. I think that's what makes him such a threat is he's a guy that's comfortable wherever you put him. He's an athletic player, athletic football player, and the coaches realize that and take advantage of his skills. And wherever that's at, he knows that he can make a difference. Last year you mentioned he was an all-conference return man in the Big Eight. Comfortable doing that, comfortable under center, running the offense, just really understanding what's expected of him and not trying to do too much, just taking what comes and plays. And that's the beauty of watching guys like that. They just love playing football. No matter where you go, put me on the field, I want to go at it.
He's got to be a tired puppy by the end of the night.
I would guess. I would think Saturday morning is not real enjoyable for him as he rolls out of bed.
If he doesn't go watch the VR game tomorrow, I understand.
Yeah.
Pre-snap.
Hey, go ahead.
Pre-snap penalty there, 5 against Sun Prairie.
I would think, much like many programs around the state, you get up and you watch film the next morning, and he probably has a group of guys that, hey, you help keep me up, I'll help keep you up.
Or he might just go play Xbox tomorrow morning,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, I mean, who knows?
There's some of that.
I think that's changed a little bit of the way these guys play, too. They see things on PlayStation or Xbox, and they understand, they recognize things.
Here's Taylor with the handoff, and he'll burst forward to about the 33. Nathan Florek still in there at quarterback. Xander started. Moved the ball a little bit for Sun Prairie, and then Florek came in and hit the big jackpot with a 56-yard touchdown pass. So Nathan Florek in on this series. He is a 6-foot, 190-pound senior, number 7 for Sun Prairie, quarterback Nathan Florek. Third down and 6 for Sun Prairie. 32-yard line. Here's the handoff to big DeMarcos Deloney. And he's going to be just stopped short a yard or two of the first down.
I've seen him block a couple times in this game with purpose. I saw an extra bounce in his step. He was so fired up to get that football handed off to him, which doesn't happen very often, but the big fella, knowing he needs some hard yards, just attacks through that hole. Good job of walling down some things. But, again, good flow by these linebackers on both sides for Sun Prairie Middleton, making a difference defensively so far here tonight.
He kind of ran like Cecil Martin there.
Yeah, big body.
Big gut, here we go, man.
Yeah. I think big shoulder pads off Cecil, though.
Yeah, that's true. Here's Oakley to punt for Sun Prairie. And it'll be down the inbounds as David Bryan jumps up in the air and grabs it, and it's going to be at the Middleton 39-yard line, and the Cardinals will get it again, trailing 7-3 here in the second quarter. Next week, we'll be right back here at Breitenbach Stadium. First appearance of the Monroe Cheesebakers on the Prep Mania football game of the week. It'll be Monroe at Edgewood here at Breitenbach next Friday night at 7 on the game of the week.
Looks like Monroe's got things right. They're brand new coach this year and playing a little more purpose. And long story program, Middleton and Monroe, long time in the Badger Conference, went head-to-head. And then Middleton obviously made the jump to the Big 8.
Huff with the carry. And good pursuit by Miguel Chestnut on the tackle for Sun Prairie.
Huff looks like he got up a little bit slow after that play. He took one big shot right at the line of scrimmage. Yeah, he got popped pretty good. Chestnut finished him off, planted him in the turf. Hard hitting out there tonight.
Gain of 3, second and 7. Huff tried to jump over the line that time, but couldn't get very far, so it's going to be third and long again for Middleton.
Really good surge underneath by those defensive linemen, David Bryan being one of them, up over the top, Will Van Peterson, Ethan Ackley coming off the edge, Ben Hauser, again, those linebackers film, but that front line has been doing a really good job. Only 3 guys for Sun Prairie, but those linebackers are reading things, getting downhill in a hurry. Just be careful that you don't go too quick, that if it's a pass play that your defensive backs don't get engaged with their eyes in the backfield, they're playing responsibility football first.
Third and 7, Middleton. Let's see if Furmanek puts it in the air. Rushes on and well defended. The pass was complete, but as soon as the receiver caught it, Marty Stry was there to get Chris Olson, the tight end. It'll be fourth down.
They're sending both outside wide receivers deep, trying to clear for some underneath routes. Marty Stry, second time tonight, gets into that curl area, gets his head around, reads the receiver, reads the quarterback, and the timing on those 2 hits that he's broken up plays with have been perfect. You can't do it any better.
Yep. Fourth and 2. Middleton in punt formation again. Furmanek lets it fly from his own 35. It's a spiral that bores into the air, and it'll roll inside the 20 and down to the 11 and almost the 10-yard line.
So tilt and field position right now. They got a really good punt last time. Sun Prairie started moving a few things. Now they get pin them deep again. Sun Prairie, though, is showing some wherewithal as they're pinned deeper inside their own red zone to be smart, ball security, take care of the football. Don't turn it over down here. But again, stay aggressive. 6.5 minutes left here in the second quarter. Middleton scored. Sun Prairie comes back and answered. Now we can start going back to a little bit of a stalemate. Who's going to be able to hold out long enough before something breaks?
I'll tell you, Sun Prairie's defense deserves a lot of credit right now. Remember, they held Middleton from getting a touchdown deep in their own territory, and then the offense turned it around, and now Middleton's in punt mode right now offensively as Sun Prairie's defense has done a nice job.
Well, and we talked about it right from the get-go. This is momentum. This is young high school kids, maybe not young. I guess there's some seniors, but they're still 16, 17, 18-year-old kids. And sometimes when the momentum, it's hard to get that back, hard to stay excited, hard to stay enthusiastic and getting after it. You got to find a way to keep that intensity level up.
People's got 9 on first down, and now he'll get a first down carry on second down out to about the 23-yard line.
And if I'm Sun Prairie right now offensively, I'm content in just grinding some time, shortening up this first half, getting first downs, trying to get out of harm's way back in your own deep in your own red zone, and trying to wear down this defensive unit for Middleton.
People's also a good track performer for Sun Prairie. He's got plenty of speed. Now here's the rush on, and it's a sack for Middleton. The linebacker Shane Bick takes down Florek.
And we talked about that with those long passes. How long can that front line hold up against this defensive front for Middleton? The 2 big passes that they hit, great job protecting. This time, Florek gets outside the pocket a little bit, needs to step up where the help is coming from, and great job by Shane Bick. Recognizing, reading, and deciding when he went, he's going to go all out, brings down Florek for the big sack. Really
loss,
good job.
Yeah, loss
there.
Of 11. If Bick doesn't get him, Nate Hellbach was right there right. To follow up. So it's second and 21 back at the 12-yard line for Sun Prairie. Back in is Jalen Taylor, and he bursts through for a nice gain.
So he gets back to third and 10, the original line of scrimmage.
Mm-hmm.
Really good burst, as you said, off that offensive line, right side. Guys walling out bodies, and the quick burst that Taylor has, he sees a hole, he reacts, and he goes. He's little, he's shifty, and he's quick. So you got to make sure when you get a hand on him, it's more than just a hand, because he'll run away from it. You got to get a body onto him.
Up front, the interior lineman for Sun Prairie, Ben Johnson, Dominic Cooper, Sam Wagner, Sam Presser, Anthony Villanueva. They're starting to open up some holes. Third down and 10 for Sun Prairie. To the sideline they go. Coy complete. First down, Cardinals. Penalty marker, though, in the Sun Prairie backfield.
They get a call or maybe a late hit on the quarterback. We'll see what they're discussing. Sun Prairie's not clapping their hands, so it looks like it might be against the Cardinals in white.
Boy, Florek got that ball out to the sideline. It hung a little bit, but Coy had enough space. Well, now they are
now
clapping.
Clapping. All right.
Oh, my goodness. This is going to go against Middleton, huh?
We'll see what the call is here.
Boy, and they'll, if they tack that out of the end of the play, that's a huge play for Sun Prairie.
No doubt.
Here's the call. Hands to the face, personal foul.
Really good route by Sun Prairie in the way they designed that. Nathan Coy's on the inside. And you got Verstegen. Nate Verstegen on the outside. He stems in a little bit. Coy kind of dips behind him, freezes the outside linebacker, prevents him from getting all the way out to the flat. Nathan Florek, a lot of Nates out there for Sunbury.
Yeah.
Really good job of throwing the football on spot. And this time, again, we saw Coy drop an interception in the first play from series defensively. He's come up with two big receptions for his offensive unit.
It was third and 10 at the Sun Prairie 23. It's now first and 10 at the Middleton 45. Here's Coy on the little bubble screen. And he'll fall forward to the 40-yard line. So that was a 32-yard play with the catch to Coy and the penalty added on. And Coy got another reception there for five.
Awfully hard for Nate Verstegen, number 13 on the outside edge. You got two receivers, three defenders. He's got to engage with one. Coy's got to make a couple guys miss. But those defenders from Middleton closed nice, kind of like that cone, pinning him down for some unknown reason. He was able to slip through those couple defenders and get a couple extra yards.
Second and five. Peoples hesitates. And he's swallowed up initially by Shane Bick, and then about five more Middleton Cardinal defenders were there to finish him off.
That's where you see a little bit of the ankle injury come into play. He's not able to plant hard, get upfield. He tried to slow himself down, but just doesn't have that same ability to adjust on a dime. And Bick coming up, holding the edge, trusting what he sees, in position to make plays. Really like watching him play.
Tom Sabalka, the longtime defensive coordinator here in Middleton, loves his linebacking crew. They moved Joe Ludwig up from the secondary to linebacker, and Caleb Cymbalak and Shane Bick.
Good crew.
Good group as they've had here in Middleton, and they've had some good ones. Third down, throwing, complete. That's Jenkins from Florek. That was the touchdown combination for Sun Prairie's score, and that one's good for another first down for the Cardinals.
I like watching receivers work. Trey Turner, number 30, is in position, and as Walker Jenkins cuts, he slips on the turf, isn't able to recover and get back, except for the tackle, but that by that time, ball was thrown. Reception, first down, Sun Prairie. Turner stays on his feet. That's going to be a lot tighter window to throw into.
Gain of 15. I tell you, Florek's moving this team through the air. He's going to try one more time. Now, if penalty marker flies, it's going to be a hold against Sun Prairie. At least that's what Scott signaled.
Yeah, I think
I believe you.
As Florek took off running, the offensive lineman don't know where you're going, so you got defensive lineman trying to disengage. A lot of times the hands go out, the jersey gets pulled, and not for anything of lack of effort, but just frustrating because you see a seam as a quarterback, and then it's got to come back. So a tough one there, but he actually had a guy floating downhill on the back, and he floats it up and over the top. That's even a bigger play, but here not so much hurt other than the penalty.
So the hold against Sun Prairie will make it first and 20 now. Ball back at the 39-yard line. 2:31 left before halftime. Chris Oldak and Dennis Semrau back at our TBW studios from ESPN Madison, 100.5. They'll be recapping the first half of this one, looking at around some of the other games around the area tonight, week two of the high school football season in 2016. First and 20. The hand is to Taylor. And Max Elliott had a hold of him. Taylor kept the legs running, though, fell forward for another yard or two.
Taylor doesn't have real big holes to run through, but when he hits them quick. So we talk about holes opening, but they close quick. Well, he's getting through there in time before that hole closes. Middleton is starting to converge, but by the time they make contact with him, he's at or past the line of scrimmage. And then, as you said, keeping your legs driving forward gets a couple extra yards by moving the pile ahead.
They'll give him a gain of four. Second and 16, 34-yard line. Here's Taylor again, and he's ridden down in the backfield by Joe Ludwig. Ludwig was nearly there to get the handoff, and he gets Taylor for a loss.
Well, you watch both inside linebackers. Everybody's blitzing, and too many bodies for the offensive line to cover up. Ludwig does a good job of getting through there, recognizing the ball is handed off, and he doesn't get into a trail position. He plants his right foot, gets down the line, and that's why he's able to bring the running back down where he did. And just a really good heads-up play by your senior linebacker.
Joe Ludwig led the Middleton Cardinals with 9 tackles last week against Madison Memorial. Of course, he's the son of Andy Ludwig, the former offensive coordinator at Wisconsin, who's now at Vanderbilt. Sun Prairie being very patient here. It's third and 20. And the clock continues to roll, now under 40 seconds before halftime. And now we will have a timeout.
They were trying to burn as much time as they could. The back judge that has a 25-second play clock started to count. And Brian Kaminsky, who's very content in just calling a timeout, wants to regroup his guys, see what they can get here, maybe get in field position for Alex Oakley, who's got a nice strong leg. Not much wind out here tonight. Maybe take a chance if they can burn a little bit more time and getting another 3 points on the board and head in with a 10-point lead.
He's in the huddle. You can't see his number, but old number 85, we mentioned him earlier. Cooper Nelson, your son.
Yep.
What's it like to have had such a great football career of your own and now watch your son playing?
Well, this is a lot harder.
is it?
Yeah, because much like, you know, any parent, when your kids are out there playing, you don't have control. When you're playing, you can control what you're doing and, right, and where you go. But it's fun, you know, as the kids grow. And I've recognized that, like, even Kevin Lyles with his son playing. Kevin and I played together at UW. It's really fun, I think, for us guys that have played at a higher level. Just enjoy watching them enjoy playing the game. It's not so much about everything other than them working hard, earning their time, and then watching the fruits of their labor come out on the field. Yeah. It's a good time.
And every parent in the stands who has a player on the field knows exactly what you're talking about, whether you played the game or not. Florek chased out of the pocket. Finds some open space. Finds a receiver. Complete. That's Jenkins. And he'll get to about the 28-yard line.
I will say this about that, Jay. Yep. It's probably a lot more comforting for me being up here with you than it would be in the stands. Take that for whatever it's worth.
Yeah, I feel good.
Yeah, yeah. Thank you for that.
Alex Oakley is a pretty good kicker for Sun Prairie, so on 4th and 9 from the 27, I'm guessing they're considering that option. And now Brian Kaminsky will take a timeout with just 2 seconds left of the clock, and here comes the field goal unit. Here's the last play that got it down to the 27-yard line.
And this is a play that Sun Prairie got a holding call on the last time. Number 77 outside the edge, Anthony Villanueva, got the holding call before. This time, keeps his hands locked in. Florek slips up underneath. Walker Jenkins shows himself to Florek. Good hard throw. Mm-hmm. And he almost broke the tackle. I was still not sure he would have got the first down. But a nice job understanding timing. And if you give a quarterback long enough, let them work. Your receivers will get open for you. And you see Walker Jenkins, who's a pretty good athlete in his own right, really good baseball player out at Sun Prairie as well, and has had an impact here as a wide receiver for them here this year.
Yeah, Jenkins was a smooth shortstop for that Sun Prairie baseball team. So, field goal attempt coming up for Alex Oakley. Did not make a field goal last week. He missed an extra point, but as we said, he's a pretty reliable place kicker. The tee is down at the 33-yard line, so a 43-yard attempt You see the holder, number 11, Lane Gugger.
I think David Bryan think, is.
Yeah,
and
Oakley's going to move it back 7 yards yep. instead of six. So here we go. This will be the final play of the first half. Oakley says he's ready. Here's the snap. Here's the boot. Oh, they might have got a piece of it. Into the end zone. And taken there by Jack Smith, but field goal well short. And that will do it.
Yeah, somebody remind Jack this isn't Canadian football. You can't catch it and return. But, hey, it forces you to think. Force them to think.
Jack Smith's got one speed.
Go.
It is. Go, man.
I love it.
Yeah, what the heck. All right, there's C.J. Firmenich and his team at home trailing at halftime. I tell you what, some Prairie's got to feel real good. They got a couple of pretty good running backs.
They
and
do.
If their quarterback can throw like that, the way their defense play, that's a pretty good combination.
Well, the second half, as they regroup, it's all about keeping the hammer down for Sun Prairie and Middleton trying to find a way to get some of the momentum back. Once Sun Prairie scored their touchdown, they've owned it. And for Middleton, it's how do we get the ball first coming out, but set the tone for the second half right out of the get-go. But like we talked, two really, really good defensive teams going at each other here tonight. And they held true here in the first half.
Our only touchdown of the first half was a 56-yard touchdown pass from Nathan Florek to Walker Jenkins. It came with 7 seconds left in the first quarter, and that has Sun Prairie ahead of Middleton at halftime, 7-3. Chris Oldak, Dennis Semrau back at our TBW studios for our halftime report coming up. You're watching the Prep Mania Game of the Week on TBW and Channel3000.com. Good half, guys. Good work. Okay. We'll take a break. I've got a studio in my ear, so. Minute and a half, I just heard you. I should be up now. Great. Thank you. Did you see the highlights? How many we got?
15.
Hello,
yeah? Cool. That'll get us there.
Yeah.
Okay. Firmenich. Firmenich. They seem to have beaten the safeties a couple of times. Beautiful. Boy, guys bounce off him, huh? Seconds. Boy, he didn't wind up very far, does he? He just kind of.
He just got a. Cannon.
Yep.
Sometimes throws it too hard.
15 okay. seconds. Yep. All right. Oh, yeah, 10. Nice shot. 5, 4, 3. Welcome back to Middleton. It's Good Neighbor Festival weekend here. Boy, this is a beehive of activity today. In addition to this football game, just across the way is Good Neighbor Festival. There was a Middleton home swim meet tonight. There's a play or some sort of thing going on at the Performing Arts Center. Parking at a premium. And
yeah.
That little carnival is going to go on past the game tonight. So.
Well, they got a little better weekend this week for Good Neighbor Fest. Sun Prairie had their
yeah.
Corn Fest last week. And
oh, yeah.
Thursday and Friday night, both it rained on them, so they had to close up early.
Man.
But tonight's a perfect night mm-hmm. for football. We've seen a really good game. We've seen a lot of activity. We've seen some great defense, all sorts of stuff, Jay. And mm-hmm. here we sit with a score at 7-3, which I kind of thought in that first half it would be low scoring. I'm not sure what we're in tail for here as far as scoring in the second half. Mm-hmm. But watch out for Middleton coming out of the gate with a sense of urgency to try and get back on the board and try and get this lead with another touchdown and go up 10-7.
And the Cardinals will receive the second half kickoff, so they'll get that opportunity right from the start. We have some highlights to take a look at from first half. It's youth football night here. St. Francis Xavier and the Middleton Cardinal Youth Football Club. Here's some of those highlights. C.J. Furmanek, the quarterback, he can beat you with his legs, and that's a nice carry here. Marty Strive stopped him on that one. Here's one of the long passes. Jack Zander had this one to Nathan Coy. And Middleton's fine running back, Dion Huff. Guys bounced off him, and there's a big gain inside Sun Prairie territory, but they only got a field goal out of that drive. So that was a big stop. As Middleton got closer, Myron Ashford on the reception from C.J. Furmanek. Here's that field goal. It was a 22-yarder drive by Joe Polisek, and that made it 3-0 Middleton, 1:27 left in the first. But then here's the big play, the touchdown pass.
Really good job by Flork. Good protection up front, getting up and over the top, and then Walker Jenkins bringing the ball in, getting out of the shoestring tackle and punching it in for Sun Prairie.
And that Sun Prairie running tandem of Draven Peoples there and Jalen Taylor had a productive first half. Here's another completion as Florek just kept hitting on passes. Another one to Jenkins there. Joe Ludwig, nice play in the backfield to stop Jalen Taylor. And here's Florek again. This time he floats out of trouble, gets to the side and hits Jenkins again. And that's a set up at a field goal attempt. Looked like C.J. Furmanek came through the line. He and Joe Ludwig were right there. 12-19, and Oakley's 44-yard field goal attempt was well short, as we said, tipped by Furmanek at it here. And there you see the gauntlet of youngsters that's ready to greet the Middleton Cardinals as they're still coming out of their locker room, still 2:35 left on the scoreboard clock. Then we'll have another three-minute warm-up period, so we are a little bit away from the start of the second half. Second week of the 2016 season. Of course, the Big 8 Conference is a little unique where there are no non-conference games. Here comes Middleton. And the Big 8, 9 regular season games, and they're all conference games. And here's where they stand right now. Sun Prairie and Middleton both winning last week, as did Madison West, Madison, La Follette, and Verona. Craig was a winner last night at Bree Stevens Field against Madison East. That was a 57-38 final, so Craig evens its record at 1-1. Parker, Beloit Memorial, Madison Memorial, Madison East all looking for their first victories of the season.
A big rivalry game, Madison West and Madison Memorial tonight. Is it for the Burt Hobley clipboard trophy? And we've done that game a number of times. Brad Murphy is the new head coach over at Madison West, was at Madison Memorial as an assistant last year. So a lot of storylines in that one. But this Big 8 conference race, certainly Sun Prairie Middleton, year in and year out are at the top. Verona, I've heard a lot of good things about Dave Richardson and his crew. So does this hold a huge leg up for whoever wins this game here tonight? Absolutely. But with 7 more to go, there's a lot of work to be done.
Well, you look at the Big 8, and you see a lot of teams that you figure are going to be good every year. And last year, 7 Big 8 teams made the postseason, but all 7 were out by the second round. That's been a bit of a trend, I guess. The only 2 playoff victories to get to the second round came against other Big 8 schools,
right,
which is kind of weird, too. So the conference season extended into the postseason. The conference hasn't won a WIA state title since 1995.
95 when Sun Prairie won, huh?
Yeah, how about that?
Sun Prairie probably was the last one, and was it 2012 to make it?
2012, well, and then Verona was in 2008 before that. But that's, you know.
That was before they were part of the Big 8, though, I think, wasn't it? They were just
That's correct. Yeah, yeah. But, you know, you think about all those teams with great traditions, and you think, boy, you know, that team was good 4 or 5 years ago.
Right.
But for whatever reason, the playoffs have been a tough sled.
It is tough, and I think that's the beauty of playoffs to me, is that you start going week by week. Now you start whittling down, and with Homestead being in there, Arrowhead being in there, Kimberly being in there, Wanakee being, I mean, there's a lot of great teams in this state that have year in and year out been right there, and we've had a great pleasure, you and I, doing this now for 10 years and seeing some great football in this conference and around the area with some of those state-caliber teams.
Well, that's a great sight, isn't it? Youth football night, and all the youngsters get to stand with the varsity warming up here to start the second half for Middleton. That's a big thrill, and
They're all going, man, maybe
they'll
someday
remember.
That's going to be.
Oh, yeah. That's a great thing. Mm-hmm. Awesome sight.
Yeah. Right, we've had so much fun over the last 10 years bringing you the Prep Mania Game of the Week on TVW and Channel3000.com. We appreciate everyone's support and watching and giving us some nice comments as well. Our great crew from Play On Sports Midwest. Derek Dombrowski running the truck for Channel 3 most nights for us. Here's our schedule coming up, of course, tonight. Sun Prairie and Middleton will be right back here at Breitenbach Stadium next week when Monroe faces Edgewood in a Badger South Conference showdown. Then back to the Big 8 as Verona visits Madison West. And back-to-back games for the Wildcats as we return to Breitenbach Stadium on September 16th when Verona comes here to play Middleton. Then we'll venture into the Badger Conference, DeForest at Mount Horeb Barnerville. That should be a dandy. Janesville Craig at Madison Memorial on September 30th. And then, well, there are certain games when we make out this schedule. One is Sun Prairie at Middleton.
Must see football, yeah.
One is DeForest at Wanakee. We say, okay, I guess I don't care who else is playing those nights. We're going to do those games. And
some great rivalry games.
Yeah, nothing against anybody else, but, man, you just stop what you're doing when DeForest and Wanakee or Sun Prairie and Middleton get together. All right. So the youngins are going to get off the field. And they're going to get a nice little sprint to wear off some energy. And
thankfully for their parents, right?
Yeah, right.
Burn off some of that Mountain Dew they've probably been drinking.
There's Brian Kaminsky giving some final instructions to his team. As we said, 14 seasons now already for Brian Kaminsky taking over for Mike Hahn. What a tradition, Sun Prairie. You know it firsthand, Scott. Over 500 wins since 1945, and there are only three head coaches in that time. Fran Sheehan, Mike Hahn, and Brian Kaminsky.
And they had a 500th win celebration last year against Beloit Memorial at home, and it was pouring rain, but there were still probably 150, 200 guys that came back from, I think there was a player back from the 1930s that came in. And when you look at that, of course, you push them out in a wheelchair, but they went from the most recent and kind of worked their way up. There was probably three or four guys in that last group, and the 2,500 people that were at that game stood up and standing. It was really cool just to be a part of that and to see that. And certainly a memory for me and my brother was there. Both my brothers were there, and our friends we hadn't seen in a long time. But that's when you have a traditional program, Middleton and Verona and Sun Prairie. There's a family atmosphere with that. You can go away for a long time. Everybody scatters to college, has families, but you come back together. And hey, you remember back when? You remember what Coach said? For whatever reason, it's burned into your memory. And of course, it's the fish story.
Well,
that gets a little bit bigger as you go. But I think we all have been a part of that at some point.
What's wrong with fish stories?
Nothing.
You know,
especially when you're the one telling it.
There you go. Oakley to kick it off for Sun Prairie to start the second half. 7-3 Sun Prairie. And a game that figures to go a long way in helping to determine who the Big 8 Conference champion is in 2016. Yeah, I know it's week two, but these are two teams that are in great position to make a run at that championship. Kick to Furmanek from the two. Furmanek, wow, he is met at the 15-yard line and driven back. Jalen Whipple, 15, was one guy in there. But he wasn't the only one. 11, Lane Gugger also. On great coverage by Sun Prairie.
Watching Whipple run down there, he did not sit back and wait on that block. He attacked it. Watch him drive on the left side of your screen, just driving his blocker back in. Ooh. And Lane Gugger comes in from the same side, inside shoulder, inside and in front. Not allowing anything to spill to the outside and packing a punch. Great way to start for Sun Prairie. And back up against the wall a little bit inside their own 20s sits Middleton.
At the 17. Furmanek to the outside. And it's open. This is the running back out of the backfield, Dion Huff. A well-crafted play by Middleton gets Huff to the edge, and he gets a big gain.
Big gain. Mistake by cornerback in Caden Kalpinen, number 47, attacks at the block, which is perfect, but he went inside, allowed that play to spill to the outside. Then you got your free safety and a linebacker coming on the edge. Next time, engage. Understand that, okay, they completed the pass already. Don't give up something big. Engage in the block, stay to the outside, force them back to the inside where your help is coming from.
Will Van Petersen on the tackle, but not before Huff on the reception, gained 24. First and 10, Middleton, 41-yard line. Just underway, third quarter. Firmenich keeps it. And he's driven down right at the 40-yard line.
I think that was Josh Dingen, number 88, on the outside edge. Maybe Ethan Ackley. I can't quite get the number. If it was Ackley, could have been him. But both guys coming on the outside edge. It was Dingen who wrapped him up first.
Yep.
And Ackley comes to help finish him off.
Yep.
Exactly what you got to do. Hang on for dear life. Pursuit. Teammates will come and help finish it.
Zach Parrish was there. Kalon Coleman, the nose tackle, was also there. So good pursuit by Sun Prairie's defense again. No gain. Second and 10, 41-yard line. Sun Prairie thought another Middleton player flinched. Yeah, they did. They did throw the flag. Pass is complete to Myron Ashford for a short gain, but a penalty marker on the far side of the field.
Before we get the call, Marty Stry, outside linebacker, out of no man's land, does a really good job of breaking down, padding his feet, and engaging into the tackle, not allowing those extra yards.
Did that Sun Prairie coaching staff talk that official into that penalty?
Did
They certainly suggested
it. I can neither
it.
Confirm nor deny that. You know, we can't tell from up here, obviously. But
I mean, the official had it. Okay, they're going to decline the penalty.
Yeah. Brian Kaminsky and Tim Simon both work the officials.
Yeah.
And they're not alone in that. But you know what? Sometimes that helps. Your players see you fighting for everything for them. They give a little bit extra. The officials are watching for things that you cue them in on. And, yeah, so sometimes you catch a break and get a flag.
Yeah. They didn't talk the official into it. They just merely confirmed it.
Confirmed it, I believe. Right call. Good job.
Oh, yeah. There you go. Trying to be supportive. Third and eight, Middleton. Big shift here. Huff the running back to the left of Firmenich. Sun Prairie shows blitz. Now here comes Hauser on the blitz and a pass. Low, incomplete, off the turf, looking for Huff. But it's going to be fourth down.
Coming different angles. Hauser showed blitz. Ackley showed blitz. They both back off. Hauser comes. They're trying to get a little slip out of the backfield. Ball's thrown low at the feet. Awfully tough catch for Middleton there and for Huff. And Marty Stry, again, number 21 on the right side of your screen. They're a linebacker, but back on punt returns. Is in position, probably going to make a play. Might gain a few yards, but again, not enough for the first.
Middleton offensive coordinator Jason Pertzborn has to be scratching his head a little bit, saying, man, how are we going to get this thing going?
Trying a little bit of everything, and right now it's just been a struggle.
Well, Firmenich has this punt turn over, and it's a beauty. It'll go inside the five and down at the three. What a punt by Firmenich. Great coverage there by Austin Delaney. He's a burner. Austin Delaney can really run, and he got down there. Looked like the ball might be scooting into the end zone, but Delaney, with a great job on special teams, puts Sun Prairie in a hole at the three.
First with Firmenich catching the ball that squibbed back to him, and to get that and then get this kickoff. And this is something as a young return man, if you're back there to catch the ball, go catch it. Don't continue to wave things off. Fair catch it if you don't want to get hit. That's fine, but you can't give up that extra 15 yards on the roll and put your offense in harm's way this way. Go after the football.
And that's the voice of experience, everybody. Scott Nelson was one of the best fair catch catchers in the history of football.
Every chance I could get.
Maybe could have returned one or two, but.
Probably. I had a few times where it was 20 yards of running, but.
Oh, that's good.
Then you hear the, well, no, in front of me that I fair
oh,
caught.
Oh,
that's
I see. Oh,
good.
You could have gone. Oh.
You hear a few of the boos at Camp Randall, but like, hey, we got the ball. I want to go rest.
That's tough to get booed at Camp Randall.
Yes. Yeah, it's all right.
They don't boo you anymore, though. That's good.
No.
Often.
I'm too old.
Second and eight. Sun Prairie trying to get out of a hole. Xander's back at quarterback, by the way. And wow, look at that stop. Max Elliott wraps up Jalen Taylor. Third down.
Taylor's trying to come on a trap play off to the right. Nothing there, so he starts to go left, and Taylor doing a really good job. We've seen that a few times.
Mm-hmm.
Elliott does a really good job of slow playing on the backside, and when he reads the play, here comes Taylor and comes right to him. Just to sound fundamentals.
Third down to the outside, and the pass is complete again. Xander hits Walker Jenkins. Jenkins a little slow to get up. Might have rolled an ankle. Maybe a cramp, I don't know, but boy, again, that ball kind of hung up, but again, a completion, and Jenkins will come out at least for a play, but that's a first down for Sun Prairie.
And that's as young receivers, again, watch these guys work. Walker Jenkins plants hard and gets out of it. Trey Turner, a little hesitation and slip on the play. Enough separation for the quarterback to thread the needle.
Wildcat here. Peebles. He handed it off to Taylor, and wow, that was read well by the Middleton defense. Looks like 47 Shane Bick on the tackle for loss for Middleton. Lost four.
He's having himself a good game defensively. You preach it, you hear me say it time and time again, shoulders square, engaging in blocks, disengaging in blocks. But guys are in gaps, and it's hard to run when you don't have any area to go through. If your offensive line can't get that initial surge, it makes it really tough.
Wildcat again. This time Peoples keeps it. And, again, a short gain. It's going to be third and very long for Sun Prairie. I like the idea of the Wildcat.
Yeah. Yeah, it backed up that way. You got two threats in the backfield as running backs, but Jack Smith and Joe Ludwig, inside backers for Middleton, having nothing of it. They're coming at you and coming hard.
Well, time to get a quarterback back in there, it looks like. So Xander, who started the game, back in there now. And he's handed a third and 12. Timeout, Sun Prairie.
Make sure you got the right things. Everybody on the same page. Backed up. We don't want to give up anything big here. Third and 12. Understand what the situation is. You can look for a draw. You can look for a screen. Wide receiver screen out on the outside edge. But first and foremost is get the snap and ball security after the plays ensued.
Look at the upcoming schedule for both of these teams. Sun Prairie next week will be at Janesville Craig. Then they'll be home to Janesville Parker, home to Beloit Memorial, at Madison Memorial, home to Madison West, and at La Follette. Middleton next week will be at Madison West, then at Janesville Craig. Home games against Verona and Parker, then at La Follette, at Beloit, and they'll wrap up their regular season here home against Madison East. It's really remarkable. I mean, you play three games before school starts.
Right.
It's just the way the calendar lines up in part. But
you go all the way to the state tournament, you're in the middle of November.
Yeah.
That's a long haul.
Some schools like Edgewood started, I think, a couple weeks ago. But the majority of schools will start after Labor Day. Okay, here's third down. High snap handled by Xander. Throws a floater and incomplete. And Ludwig lit up the receiver, Jalen Taylor. Oh, that's a free shot from Joe Ludwig,
yeah.
Huh? Ooh.
That's one as a defensive player you dream about because a quarterback floats the ball. Did I get a good enough break to intercept it? He didn't. He reads it, times it out, sort of like we've seen Marty Stry do on the opposite side for Sun Prairie. Lowers it, good shoulder into the belly. That's one as you're running back, your receiver, you go back to your quarterback. Don't ever do that to me again.
Yes.
Either that or give me the ball and you run the route and I'll throw it to you.
Fourth down, Oakley to punt. Firmenich and Trey Turner back to receive. This is going Firmenich's way. He's telling everybody to get out of the way, and this is going to be a good roll for Oakley. Wow, it's going to go 34-yard line and scooped up there by David Bryan for Sun Prairie.
Another
it's the same deal.
The same thing, yeah. It's an extra 15 yards that your offense has to go now. Breathe the kick off his foot. Get there. If nothing else, fair catch it. If you can't get to it, fine. Bail on it. But at least make a dead sprint effort to go after the football.
If you want to take a couple minutes, go down and tell them.
Yeah. I mean, yeah. I'll go right ahead and do that.
I'll fill time
cover?
Until
you
get back. Yeah.
Yeah, right.
Looks like we've got a new quarterback in there for Middleton. That's number 8, Davis Rocket. Handoff. Huff with a couple of slippery moves. He'll gain 4.
I see Firmenich walking on the sideline. Probably just needs a little break for, as we talked, with all the activity he's doing, returning, playing quarterback, playing defensive back, all that stuff. Just needs a slight break here. And heads up for Middleton to get him in there and rock it in there. And here you go. Here's your chance to shine. And now we build a little depth. We know that if Firmenich has to go down and take a break or gets injured, we've got a capable backup.
Yep. Temperatures slipping into the 60s tonight, right around 70 at game time, and a little humid, so that can get you a little fatigued as hard as Firmenich's been working. Another running play. Huff gets to the 40. Marty Stry, another stop.
A looks like third and four. Good surge off that side of the right offensive line. And then a little cut back as he walks down that wall. Again, slow playing Stry, Hauser, those guys in the back edge, and then squeezing things down and packing a punch. A lot of communication has to happen on that defense.
Big play here for Middleton. Third and four at the 40. Rocket to the outside. Yes, pass complete, and then some. Huff gets a first down into Sun Prairie territory. Van Peterson there to help make the stop. First down, Middleton.
Saw communication happen between Stry and Hauser. Stry's on the inside. Hauser has to recognize that and be on a dead sprint. He gets in a trail position, so that's all about angles, trusting what you see and going where you can meet the receiver, not getting on the back edge in trail position. Gives up a big first down, but you know what? No touchdown, lineup and play again. Middleton's starting to get the momentum you talked about.
Caden Koppinen also on the tackle for Sun Prairie. Now here's a play that's roped down in the backfield. Miguel Chestnut. He grabbed James Papps for a one-yard loss.
And Chestnut, I don't believe, played last week against Madison East, so fresh and hungry.
He's made a few
nice
plays tonight.
He has.
Yeah. 29 right there.
Not your typical defensive line number, but 5'10", so low center gravity, but 210 pounds. Good, strong effort.
He's a senior, letter winner last year for Sun Prairie. Rocket still at quarterback for Middleton. Throws to the far side, nearly intercepted, and it's a completion to Ashford. Boy, I don't know how Zach Parrish didn't make that interception, but it got through, and Ashford made the catch.
Well, Zach Parrish, you're going to want that again.
Yeah.
It just mistimed his jump. He's listed at 6 foot. I'm not sure he's that tall.
He's not going to like this replay either.
But Ashford a little bit over 6 foot.
Okay, that was the play before.
Yep. But that just mistimed the jump. He's sitting right where he needs to be in position. The ball thrown in a perfect spot for your defensive back and just a little bit over. But a great job by your receiver working back to the ball and making the reception.
Third and two. That's going to be right at the first down line. It looks like he's got it. That was a run by James Pabst. Well, this is going to be very close to you see the. Yep, they're going to give him the first down. Middleton first down to the 37-yard line. Nice drive together here with Rocket at quarterback and giving C.J. Firmenich a little breather.
This is the first momentum sustained drive Middleton has had since they put 3 points on the board. Testing this Sun Prairie defense right now. Can they blow up and make a stop? Middleton's got that momentum.
Met at the line of scrimmage. That was Pabst.
Met by Ethan Ackley, sophomore linebacker, 195 pounds. Squared up, wrapped him up. Really good, solid form tackle by the sophomore linebacker. Again, reading the play, trusting what you see, and when you see it, react and go.
It's third quarter moving right along, 3.5 minutes left. We haven't had a score since the first quarter. Middleton field goal, Sun Prairie touchdown, all in our first period. Play action, Rocket throwing, completing. That's the tight end, Chris Olson, a 6'1 senior.
Locked in man coverage, Caden White, a free safety, covering down on the tight end. Nice job of form tackle again, third long situation. Understand down and distance where you are in the field on the hash, understanding wide side, what have they done to you before. Tried a couple little flare screens to the outside to wide receivers. They've tried to leak a running back out. Just remember what's happened, understand the play call and situation, and then read and react.
Third and six from the 33. Rocket throwing, and throwing high, incomplete. Chris Olson wanted a flag, none coming.
Good pressure coming off the edge, forcing a quick high throw. Defensive back, I don't think interfered. I do think he slipped underneath him and just startled the receiver just for a second. Again, good pressure coming off the edge. He's got a step, can't quite step all the way through, but just at the end, you see him tuck underneath. Good no call by
That's
the officials.
That's nothing, yep. Okay, a little bit too long for a field goal attempt. It'd be a 50-yarder if they tried it. So Rocket brings the offense to the line. Fourth and six from the 33. Big play here. Rushes on. Rocket throwing and incomplete. Myron Ashford Jr. got a hand on it, but the pass was a little wide, and Sun Prairie gets it back on downs.
Tough, tough throw by Rocket. Threw a dart out to the outside edge. Ashford, great, great effort in trying to go back and get that football. Almost was able to catch it on the sideline, keeping feet in bounds, but pressure coming, running backwards, put it on the spot. He might have been short even if he caught that just by him working back, but heck of a play by those two guys.
But Rocket is like
running away
when he's throwing it, and that's just not going to get
her
done.
That's hard.
Yep. All right, Sun Prairie, first down, 33-yard line. Pass, oh, what a catch. Not for a whole lot of yardage, but 44. Andre Johnson, the tight end, with a nice grab.
Andre Johnson, one of the senior co-captains, does a really good job engaging and blocks good strong out on the edge, and this is his time to get after it. Nice double catch on his part.
That's one of the better one-yard receptions you'll see.
Sure is.
Second and nine, ball 35. Clock running, 2:40 left, third quarter. Xander's back at quarterback for Sun Prairie. Gets some air under this one, and he was looking for Walker Jenkins. The closest one to the play was Middleton safety Jack Smith. Incomplete.
A little double route. That time you got your free safety up and over the top. Jack Smith is having nothing of that. He read that. That's where you got to be patient as your quarterback. Try that punt. Get that safety to go. But look on your backside route and the post route by Nate Verstegen. That's going to be wide open in the middle of the field.
So now here's a critical play for the Sun Prairie offense. Third and eight, 35-yard line. Their own 35. Here's Xander. Rushes on, and he's sacked. Nate Helbach was there for Middleton. Loss on the play. It's going to be fourth down.
Big play coming up at the right time for Middleton Cardinals. It's like an interception defensively. The sack is just as good on a third and long situation. Great job working and working and working from the backside as a quarterback doesn't even see him coming. It's where you got to set your feet on the outside edge, sink, get back. And if that's going to happen, you better yell at your quarterback, the guy's coming.
The old lookout block, huh?
That's right.
Fourth down, Oakley to punt. End over end. It'll bounce at the 40-yard line and immediately go out of bounds. Wow, there's quite a hit there as Cole Ragsdale just leveled one of the Sun Prairie players.
Still heavy hitting going on, right?
Caden Kalpinen got a
little eye-opener.
Got a little eye-opener, yep. All right, looks like Rocket's still going to be the Middleton quarterback. Now I got to look to make sure number 12's okay.
Yeah, he's sitting down right about the 40-yard line.
He's right there.
He's okay. I think they're just trying to spell him, know that they're going to need him defensively.
Keep him for
the
fourth quarter. Yeah.
And if Rocket's doing this well, you got a little drive, a little momentum going.
Yep.
Ride the wave.
And they will. So number eight now slips back into a shotgun. His running back is Dion Huff. In motion, Noah Helbach. This is Huff. Well, the yards are getting harder to come by on the inside as Sun Prairie continues to plug the holes against that big and talented Middleton offensive line.
Van Peterson is down. I don't know. I think he just got the wind knocked out of him. He went right down, just kind of put his legs up. That's an uneasy feeling when you get popped in a pile like that. You can't breathe, but I think he's all right.
Yeah.
Just by the way he rolled out, I didn't grab an ankle or a knee or anything, but.
But there now. Okay, they're looking
maybe he's cramping.
Yeah.
That's no fun either.
Yeah. You know, last week at Winona Grove, I'm just speaking of the Winona Grove game. I mean, we've had so many cramping issues early in the season, it seems, the last few years with heat and humidity. And it was a warm, sticky night, but there wasn't a whole lot of cramping that night. And I don't know if that's because they take care of their preventative. And
yeah, you talk about school starting later. I think the kids are much more aware of what they're eating and drinking when they don't have school. When you get in school and you're in class all the time, you don't have a water bottle with you all the time. So that's where you start to hit that maybe late August, early part of September. I'm not surprised, or I guess I am surprised, that more guys didn't cramp the last few weeks because it was really hot and humid.
Yeah.
But again, maybe the athletic trainers, kids are actually taking that to heart now. Drink on Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. If you wait till Friday, it's too late. Yeah. Eat a good meal. Let your body absorb some of that stuff so it has fuel to burn as opposed to try and suck everything out of the muscles that you're using here on a hard-fought, yeah, contested night.
When you played high school, what years was that?
86, 7, and 8.
What was it like with water and breaks back then?
Not so much like they do now. And back then, a lot of guys were going both ways, so you were lucky to get a water break during the game. Halftime was big. But
did they encourage it?
Yeah, they didn't certainly deny anything that way. No.
Because, you know, for a long time, that was a bad honor not to drink. Right. Yeah.
And I think the hardest part probably was when you're in the middle of August. It's 95, sometimes 100 degrees with heat index and things. That's when it gets hard. But I think the more that people have those water wheels and things that way, that it's more accessible for the kids. And obviously they've seen the benefit of hydrating over and over.
I don't think they invented heat index when you played.
Rocket. Did he throw that or fumble
I don't know. I think they're looking like they're calling it a fumble. Nope, incomplete.
Back official's incomplete.
Well, that was an odd-looking throw, that's for sure. But Rocket almost made a critical mistake. Well, they did have heat indexes when you had.
Yeah, I'm not that old. I think that's when they invented it.
We had black and white TV when I was in school. There you see the play again. Turned out okay for Middleton, but boy, that could have been disaster.
Yeah. So here's another third long situation, Jay. What is Sumpray going to do? Can they dial up the pressure and get a sack like Middleton this last series? What are they going to be able to do as they get spread out and they got guys all over the place? Lock on, get a good jam, make sure you understand who's going where and covering who, but you got to get some pressure up front.
Are they going to put it on the arm of Rocket? Let's see. Steps up, throwing deep, has a man, Ashford, he's got it to the 15. What a throw.
Oh, perfect, right on the money, going right at a senior defensive back and Nathan Coy for Sun Prairie, running a route, got on the top side of him. Coy is late in recovering, lost the receiver with his vision. He tries to recover late, but a beautifully thrown football, drops it on a dime. Right inside to the 15-yard line. A beautiful throw and catch.
That's for 31 yards.
There you go. Dial it up. Third long again, and Middleton comes up with a huge, huge play.
Myron Ashford putting together a nice night, the receiver for Middleton. Cardinals now knocking on the door at the 15. Late third quarter. Huff. Stacked up.
Marty Stry going right at his blocker. I can't tell what number of it's 48, I think, might be for Middleton. If I got maybe 49.
49, probably Noah Hellbach.
Noah Hellbach, yeah. So he blows over that and comes up with a huge, big tackle.
Sun Prairie player slow to get up. That's Ben Hauser. You see, we mentioned the big brace on his left elbow.
Looks like this might be lower leg, by the way. He's kind of hobbling.
Hauser's a tough guy, though.
Yep.
If there's any way he can get back, it's got that stiff leg that looks like it could be a cramp, but well, it might be more than that. Let's see. We'll try and keep an eye on Ben Hauser is being attended to now. Hauser is headed to the Air Force Academy to play baseball. I bet he has half a mind to do baseball and football.
He might.
That'd be tough.
That would be hard.
That would be really tough.
My older brother went to the Air Force Academy, and doing one is hard enough. Doing nothing is hard enough. That's a totally different. You throw school and the military and the training and all that stuff together. Those guys at the service academy obviously have something special about them on the inside. And Ben's a great kid. It was really cool. I read some information from Dennis Semmer on C.J. Firmenich and Hauser this week. And two really good students obviously have their heads on right that way. And it's fun to read and understand these kids a little bit more intimately that way than just what you see on the field.
And that leads me to that article Dennis Semmer wrote about, it's called The Prep Profile. He did Ben Hauser. 4.0 student. He's a senior in high school, right? His favorite subject or class? Anatomy or space and aviation?
Yeah, and
everybody else says Phi Ed or recess.
Well, I read about him when he announced that he was going to the Air Force Academy. They do all Twitter and all that stuff, but he said his neighbor taught the aviation class, and he just loved it. Fell in and said, you know what, I want to try and be a pilot. And you talk to him a little bit more, I want to be a doctor too. So obviously a motivated young man.
Well, Rocket throwing, complete to Huff. Breaks a tackle. Not that one, though. Boy, hard running by Huff. Finally brought down. Caden White finally finished him off. And that's going to do it for the third quarter.
Nice job splitting two defenders, breaking the tackle. Huge play. Again, a momentum carrier in here to the fourth quarter. Just a great job of breaking through. Ethan Ackley overruns it. Number 31
Parrish.
And Zach Parrish goes down low waiting for help to come. And Ackley's only a sophomore. That's a learning and teaching point. You got to come in, break yourself down, and pack a punch. You can't over-pursue on a tackle.
End of the third quarter. It'll be Middleton ball, third and eight from the eight when we come back. You're watching the Prep Mania Game of the Week on TVW and Channel3000.com. We got a ball game tonight.
Yep. I love it.
Mm-hmm.
Shootout in a different kind of way.
Yeah.
Not in points, but just grinding it out. I love
it. Yeah. The Sun Prairie defense could use another situation like they did the last time with that field goal.
Very true.
30 seconds. Big finish, fellas. Big finish.
I don't see Hauser out there yet.
Yeah, that didn't look like a cramp, did it?
No.
That looked a little more than that. Okay, get ready, y'all. 10, 5, 4, 3. We're back to Middleton to start the fourth quarter. It's third and two from the six for the Cardinals. Here's the running back, Huff. And he's going to be short of the first down. He needs to get to the four. Or did he get it? No, he did get it.
He did, yeah.
First down.
Close. Zach Parrish, who we talked about before, number 31, comes flying in the outside, reaches out, arm tackle. Awfully dangerous. Mm-hmm. A lot can go wrong defensively that way. And he was rolling on the ground. He's holding his right arm right now. Good, strong, hard run. A break in the tackle by Huff. And Parrish is feeling the repercussions of that. Pack a punch, get yourself squared up, get in the gaps, don't allow that surge to come forward. Watch him to go off the right side over big 77.
First and goal from the five. Hellbach and Ludwig leading the way for Huff. Here's Huff right up the middle. And stop just short of the goal line. 47, Caden Kompanen kept pulling Huff back just short.
77, 76. Horst and Lyles, two big horses in there. Now you're sitting about one and a foot.
Yeah, yeah.
Maybe.
Kompanen kept Huff out of the end zone, but not by much. There you see 55, David Bryan. He's limping around a little bit.
It's been tough going down there. Yeah. These guys are getting tired. It's been pounding left and right. And this is time you got to suck it up and go after it.
Huff again. Touchdown, Middleton. Deion Huff with a one-yard score to put the Cardinals back in front. Well, that time that offensive line got a great push.
Sure did.
That was a relatively easy one-yard run.
Last two series, they've really owned the line of scrimmage, done a tremendous job of getting surge. Sun Prairie starting to get a little bit tired. We talked about that. Who's going to be able to hold up in the trenches longer, Sun Prairie or Middleton? Well, Middleton just scores. Extra point is pending here. You got 10:53 left here in the fourth quarter. Looks like we got a false start maybe on the offense.
Yeah, they're pointing Middleton's way. It is.
So 10:53 left. That Sun Prairie offense has to come out. They got to sustain a drive, give those defensive players a chance to rest, get down the field, tilt the field, see what you can come up with, and get that momentum back on your side. You got to find a way to answer, at least get in field goal position for Oakley to try and give it a shot at to tie it up.
25-yard extra point attempt for Polisek, and it's good. Nice job by the Middleton junior kicker with that extended extra point try. So it's 10-7 Middleton, 10:53 left, fourth quarter.
You see Ben Hauser on the far side trying to work that ankle off and limping around. They'll need him back if they got to go back on the field. But this touchdown run, again, what you see is just power football right up front, a couple of big bodies in the back and a huge hole engaging on a block. Man. And then Huff just reading, knowing he needs a foot to get a touchdown. If the offensive linemen set their feet in the end zone, he's going to get in the end zone.
So,
just a really good
surge. Yeah, so Lyles is the first guy pushing, and then Hellbach and Ludwig come.
Yep. Yeah, that's awfully tough to defend, especially without
like,
your senior middle
Huff's
linebacker.
Like, thank you, guys. Yeah. Here I go. Yeah, without Hauser, right?
Right.
Yeah. Okay. So only our second touchdown of the night. And Middleton back in front. Polisek ready to kick it away from his own 40-yard line. Still 10:53 left. So who's your quarterback for Sun Prairie right now, huh?
That's a great question.
Flip a coin.
Great question. The momentum that they had, Nathan Florek was riding that out there in the end of the first quarter, second quarter. I think sometimes you got to go to the veteran guy, but I don't know. They both played well tonight, both made some mistakes.
Kickoff to the five. Taylor. Here he goes. Taylor with some running room. Just short of midfield. Great return by Jalen Taylor, who got past the first wave of coverage. And then he really turned it on.
Well, if it's not going to be your offense, you start out with a great special teams return to give some great field position to your offense. The 47-yard line, great job blocking up front, being patient and letting those blocks get set up. And then making a couple guys miss, busting to the outside. Just be very careful when you cut back in. Protect the football so guys don't come from behind and pop it out.
The quarterback will be Nathan Florek, the senior. He's had a good night. And he's in there now in a critical situation. 10-7, Middleton back in front. Taylor. Tries to bounce it outside, but can't get away.
Got a little love tap from Nathan Florek to get back to the line of scrimmage. Otherwise, it would have been at least a two-yard loss.
Luke Ballwig all the way up from his safety position to make the tackle.
Middleton dials it up. They bring pressure off the edge. They jam the stuff in the middle. They get after a little bit. Good, strong, hard blocks up front by that offensive line. Have to create a surge.
High snap. Handled by Florek. Now he's flushed out of the pocket. That's going to be a penalty against Sun Prairie. Florek throws it incomplete. Somebody grabbed a Middleton defensive lineman in the backfield.
Again, quarterback scrambling. You're trying to engage in the block. Guys trying to pull away from you as they go, trying to reach. And you end up getting a hold. And all it takes is a little bit of the jersey pull, and the official's going to throw the flag.
They're going to decline this?
Boy, it's second and ten.
They're going to take it.
Well, because the hold happens probably
that's
6
true.
Yards back, so
sure.
They go from there.
So that's essentially going to be a 16-yard penalty. 10 from the spot of the foul. Yeah, you're right.
That might even be a 20-yard penalty. I think they started marking
smokes.
From the 48-yard line. 46. Well, wow.
That's a lot of real estate.
Yes, sir.
All the way back to the 28.
Well, that kind of takes out your great kick return, doesn't
it? Yeah, a little bit. That's a 19-yard penalty.
Wow. A lot of work to be done.
Yeah. Second and 30. What do you got?
Hope and a prayer.
Florek tries a floater. Ooh, Coy nearly made the catch. Shane Bick was defending. Did a penalty marker fly?
Came all the way from the sideline.
Wow.
All the way over to the far hash.
Yeah. The penalty marker is essentially at the line of scrimmage, but it came from another area code.
Maybe a little help from the coaching staff again. Unless they call roughing the passer. That's about the area that Florek had thrown it from.
No reaction from the Sun Prairie players yet. I think they're walking toward the Sun Prairie goal here. Or are they? Oh, no, they say it's against Middleton. At least the players do. Boy, this could be a huge call,
yeah.
Huh?
If it is a personal foul, I'll give you a first down.
Personal foul.
Second down?
Okay.
I guess it's second down by mistake.
So not an automatic first down, but it'll sure help the Sun Prairie cause. Exactly 10 minutes left in the fourth quarter.
Well, they got 15 of the 19 yards back.
Yeah.
They'll take it anywhere they can get it,
I guess. No kidding. Well, at least it's a little more manageable now. It's second and 15.
True.
Ball out to the 43-yard line.
Yeah, you don't feel the presence of your own goal line looming behind you.
Florek calls the signals. Florek, good protection. Throwing, has his man. That's going to be a first down and more. Andre Johnson, first down.
Really good job of being patient. They bring twins over to the left-hand side of that offense. They run crossing routes, pull the corner, pull the safety. Johnson's on the far right side, and he drags all the way across a deep 10-yard route, 15-yard route. Patience, really good protection up front for Florek to locate him. Really well-designed play. Outstanding job then by Johnson of bringing that ball in, getting the first down, a huge pickup for them on second down.
Luke Ballwig made the tackle, but not before Johnson got down to the 23, and Florek's going to throw again, and that one's batted out of the air and complete. That was Max Elliott getting a big paw up and knocking it away.
Defensive linemen can learn an awful lot. You get engaged in a block, you're stuck, you know you can't get there. Find the quarterback, read his eyes, get your paws up in the air. A big play like that can happen.
Second and 10. Well, another thing we can read from that is that they have confidence in Nathan Florek throwing the ball, huh? And one more time. Well, that time he was looking for Johnson, but it was just a bit outside. Third down.
Coach Kaminsky's a little fired up talking to Nathan. That's one that you got to have because this puts you in a tough, tough situation at third and 10. Predictable as far as a pass is concerned. Defense can play aggressive up front a little bit, but that back end, understand where you're at. Nothing deep behind you, everything in front. See the ball come to you.
If they don't gain a yard, it'd be a 40-yard field goal attempt, possibly for Oakley. Well, then they're not going to gain anything there. 61, Roman Kreshak with a big play.
That's just a blown assignment up front by the offensive line. A little miscommunication. Two guys engaged on one player. He comes flying in free. Again, opportunistic defense. We saw that before. Who was it? I think Max Elliott came off the backside and did a really good job of bringing down your quarterback. Mm-hmm. This time, right up the middle, defensive lineman is unblocked. Makes a huge play. Here's a big kick now for Alex Oakley. A 42-yard field goal attempt.
Oakley's got a good leg. He tried one from 44 earlier that was partially tipped by Middleton. And we're going to have a timeout, I think, by Middleton.
I think they were one player short.
You hate to burn those timeouts now,
yep.
Don't you?
Both Coach Simon and Kubelka did the thing where they took the headset off. They wanted to throw it. Just furious. And then you see a player quick run on there, and he's like, oh, I'm going to be in so much trouble.
There's Tom Cebulka right there, the longtime defensive coordinator. I don't ever want to be in a position where Tom Cebulka is taking off his headsets and looking at me.
I know, scratching his head just ready to. Good coach.
Yeah,
and I think the
fantastic
players will run through a brick wall for him, but yep, he's an intense man.
He's also the head boys golf coach at Middleton. Runners up in the state boys golf tournament last June at University Ridge. Okay, here's Oakley. He's looking to tie the game. They'll spot it at the 32 and a half. So Oakley certainly has the ability to hit it from here. Oh, boy, he nailed it, too. It is no good.
Wow.
Plenty of distance, but just wide.
That's good from another 15 yards back as far as distance is concerned. I didn't see him wave. Did it go right or left? I couldn't tell from our vantage point here. It looked like it went through, but
I thought it was right down the middle, but again, we don't have a great angle. I think it might have been pushed right.
Boy, he got all of that one, though.
Oh, he did. Ooh, boy, that was a good opportunity for Sun Prairie. Let's see. Again, this is the angle we have from the press box. Let's see if you can tell. But you'll see that thing sail up in the air. Holy smokes. Yeah, that's right, isn't it?
Wow.
Anyway, Middleton has it back. Handoff to Huff. Not much doing on that first down carry for Deion Hoff.
Nice job by Ethan Ackley, linebacker again, coming in, flowing from the backside. Ben Hauser, number 9, is back on the field, so that's good news for the Cardinals. But they're going to need their best effort here right now. 8 minutes left, 8-plus left here in the fourth quarter. They got to get a stand.
That Ben Hauser's a superhero or something.
Yeah, he's still limping around, but he's going to give it all he's got.
He wasn't even supposed to play football this year, and then wasn't supposed to play later tonight after he got hurt, but he's back. Rockets still quarterbacking for Middleton. Here's a little bubble screen again, and Myron Ashford, or is that? It's going to be a first down for Middleton.
It is Ashford, yep.
Yeah, Myron Ashford Jr., another first down reception.
I just watched Hauser on that play. He's going to come off. He can't even run on that leg. So Troy Nelson, another senior linebacker, comes in to replace him. But
doggone it.
Really nice play. A little different type of bubble screen on the outside edge. Went to the far side instead of the number 3 receiver. Nice play call by Middleton.
12-yard pickup, first down. Huff on the carry. Might have got back to the line of scrimmage.
Better surge up front. Getting some pressure. About a 2-3 yard gain. So for some Prairie's defense, that's a win. Build off of that. Mm-hmm. For Middleton, hey, we'll take 2-3 yards at a crack. We're burning more time. We'll take our time. We'll just keep grinding this thing out. We'll get a big play again. We trust our offense that what the plays calls that come in from the sideline, that we can execute and win this thing.
Rockets had the last 3 or 4 series now at quarterback for Middleton. He was the quarterback when the Cardinals took the lead. 10-7, they'd love to milk a couple of minutes off the clock. Rocket, oh my gosh, is that a fumble? It's a fumble, and Sun Prairie has recovered. Rocket was just a little careless with the football. Ethan Ackley gets the recovery, but Sun Prairie set up deep in Middleton territory.
Bringing pressure, getting guys shooting through gaps. A great surge. The one time they held up 2-3 yards. Watch this offensive line just kind of sit back in a pass. Great job. Chestnut coming in again.
It's Chestnut again. I think he just lost the ball.
He's trying to throw it, deliver it, and Chestnut's in his way. As he went back, the ball slips out of his hand. That's what pursuit will get you. Ethan Ackley didn't give up on the play. Comes up with a huge fumble recovery. It's time for Sun Prairie to figure out an answer here, but this defense has stopped them before, stalled that offense in positions like this before. Look for them to continue to come and dial up that pressure.
Florek's at quarterback, Peoples back at running back, and Peoples gets the carry, and he carries a couple of Middleton tacklers inside the 15. What a turn of events this is. Oakley missed the field goal from 42. But Sun Prairie gets the ball right back on the fumble by Rocket and the recovery by Ethan Ackley. Now Sun Prairie has to do something with it.
This is where your offensive line, you got to challenge, but they got to get lathered up. They got to really take it to this defensive front. But that Middleton defense, again, hard nose, found sound fundamentally.
This is Taylor. Taylor to the 5 and to the 3. First down, Sun Prairie. Jimmy Frucciati made the tackle, but not before Taylor gets inside the 5.
I was just going to say, watch Taylor take Frucciati for a ride. Doesn't need a big hole. Slippery. Gets through there, and then watch. Dragon. 1, 2, 3 defenders. That's what you need out of the offensive line for a guy like Taylor. Just a little seam. Watch him squirt through it.
Jack Smith also went for a little ride there as Taylor with a big run. Now a tremendous opportunity for Sun Prairie. They're down to the 4-yard line. They're going to throw. Corner of the end zone. Touchdown, Sun Prairie. Nate Verstegen. We haven't said his name all night. But at 6-6, he went up and got it. And Sun Prairie goes back in front.
Really good throw. Really good catch. And quite honestly, really good defense by C.J. Furmanek. He was in perfect position. That's what height gets you. That's what you get when you're aggressive as a receiver, going back to attack for the football. Furmanek almost knocked that out of his hands, but he had the wherewithal to secure in his hands, get his foot down inbounds. A heads-up play by your quarterback to place it where he can go get it. Again, all around, 3 really good plays by those players. I guess Verstegen was just the one that found out a way to finish.
Alex Oakley for the extra point to make it a four-point lead. He does. Sun Prairie 14, Middleton 10.
I really don't know if you can play that much better than Firminick did right there. He's in position. Verstegen just went up over the top of him. Perfectly thrown football here. Just a nice timing route. He's got to take one step. Watch this thing float, but Firminick is right there. You just got to read, react. The eyes, the hands. As soon as that goes up, you got to react as a defensive back just a little bit too late.
Nathan Florek wasn't the starting quarterback in this game. Remember that?
Right.
He's thrown two touchdowns. He's had a couple of other throws that were just beautiful, too.
Yeah, he's played himself a heck of a ball game tonight. And last week, when you look at the stats and things, he was probably 10 yards away from having a touchdown pass up over the top to Nathan Coy. He had another one that they showed, at least from watching the film, that was disallowed on a similar play from Florek that way. So he's had two really solid games back-to-back. And, again, a smart ball player that's waited his time behind J.P. Curran to get the starting nod. And he's making the most of it here tonight in the biggest game so far this year.
Sun Prairie has answered both Middleton scores, and Sun Prairie now up 14-10. Here's the return by Firminick from his 10. He has a seam. He has one man to beat. Firminick's in the clear. 40, 30, 20, 10. Touchdown, Middleton. I guess he still has a little energy left, huh? 90-yard return.
That's what sitting on the sideline during offense will get you, a little bit of rest, a little bit of burst. It doesn't take much. They set up the wall really well. I think Chestnut came in trying to blow up that back wedge and then a really good job engaging on the blocks down the field, and the rest is history. Firminick to the house. A great answer after Sun Prairie score.
What a punch in the gut for Sun Prairie, huh?
But there's still 5:17 left.
Yeah, that's true.
We had a 7-3 ball game at half. Nothing scored in the second quarter. Now they're starting to erupt a little bit.
Man. Well, once he had the kicker to beat, Firminick was in good shape. So right after a touchdown pass to Nate Verstegen, C.J. Firminick flips the script, returns the kick for a touchdown. Polisek's extra point is good. 17-14 Middleton.
Just like that.
That's what makes Friday night so much fun, isn't it?
As coaching staffs now, hey, okay, keep that intensity, but it's got to be a controlled intensity. You can't be so high when you go out on the field with that adrenaline. You forget what you're supposed to do. Go out there now and execute. Make sure, as a kick team, you cover down. A great job here, though, of engaging on blocks, a huge seam, and then one guy to beat. Nice simple cut, but a guy like we talked about with Firminick, an athletic ball player. Not a great quarterback, but a great athlete, and that's what's fun to watch.
I'm going to give him 91 on that.
I think
he caught it at the 9. Wow, what a return. That's why he's all conference.
That's right.
Right there. Tell you what, Middleton had a great kick returner a number of years ago. Nick Toon, I think, was the most dangerous kick returner I've ever seen in high school. It got to the point where people would not kick anywhere near him because he'd just kill him.
Well, that would be my advice. Don't kick to CJ anymore, anybody
in
the league.
Too late.
Yeah, right.
Polisek to kick. Kind of a little pooch to Coy. He's at the 10. Coy trying to answer to the outside. 40. 47-yard line, maybe the 48. Oh, man. Special teams are going to look at some tape after this one.
So we've talked about this a number of games that we've done. Here comes your heavyweight fright, right?
Yeah.
Who's taking a couple jabs? Who's got an uppercut? Here comes a roundout. This is getting fun. And like I told you, I love defensive games. I love getting after it that way. But when it opens up, this is exciting. This is what players love. This is what coaches like. The fans love it in the stands. Yeah, this is exciting, but this is turning into a slugfest.
Great stuff. Florek at quarterback. Hands to Taylor. Working his way into Middleton territory. under 5 minutes to go. He went from 148 to the other 48. Second and six coming up for Sun Prairie.
Play calls coming in from the sideline. Sun Prairie adjusting where they're going. Now communication on down the line.
Taylor.
Hanging
Harrison
Bielski
had him around the waist. Harrison Bielski, a 5'11 senior, number six.
He wrapped him up good. He tried to jump and launch him backwards, and Taylor still keeping those feet moving, driving forward for a couple yards, but this is do or die here right now for Sun Prairie. Four down territory for sure.
Gain of only one. Third and five at the Middleton 47. As we hit the four-minute mark of the fourth quarter. Florek, slant, Verstegen, first down. He got past Furmanek again, and Verstegen with that big frame latched on and got it to the 35.
Just a quick slant route. It's one step for your quarterback in the shotgun. Verstegen plants hard on his left foot, cuts inside. Best thing he did after he caught the football is he covered up. He knew he was going to get hit, was not going to lose the rock.
Florek again, flush to his right, throws, nearly intercepted, and was it a catch?
Back judge is saying no, he's coming in incomplete.
I didn't think so.
That's a great effort, though, and he's lucky that wasn't intercepted. He was in the grasp.
Was that Max Elliott back in coverage? Number seven,
yep.
Max Elliott, boy, I think he got a piece of it. And then Johnson still almost made the reception.
Yep. Great effort all around.
Incomplete. Second and 10 at the 35. 3:39 left. Again, they don't need much more to get Oakley a reasonable shot at a field goal attempt if they need that. Florek, blitz on. Bubble screen again. Coy, I believe.
Yep.
He gets inside the 30. And a Middleton player very slow to get up in the backfield.
Looks like it was Hellbach, number nine. I don't know what happened there, but he got up pretty quick. Elliott was helping him up. A couple D linemen going at it with each other.
Third and four from the 29. They're going to give it to Taylor. Taylor bursting. First down, Sun Prairie.
Well, we saw the Middleton offensive line take control in the last couple of drives that they had. Sun Prairie starting to do the same. This high tempo, quick tempo offense that they're running right now. Has the defensive line tired, has guys limping around a little bit. They're not sure who's doing what, who's going. They're just trying to tee off and plug some gaps. And Sun Prairie's offensive line very calm and poised with what they're doing up front.
Taylor again. Well, that snap was a little low, and that kind of fudged up the timing of the play. Harrison Bielski first on the scene, number six for Middleton.
And that slows things down a little bit for that defense. Gives them a chance to kind of regroup, to suck it up, to get some wind. Offense has to regroup and call their plays. But Bielski, as you said, slipped through there. Really good job of engaging and getting off the block of number 65, Sam Wagner, who's the center. Just needs to continue to move his feet and drive him out.
They are well within Oakley's field goal range. Another slant to Verstegen. And they got it past a diving Furmanek. First down. No, they get a completion for Sun Prairie. I think it's going to be just short of a first down.
Looks like he's a yard short with where the official spotted the ball.
Third and one, Middleton.
That slant is working. They're going right senior on senior. So far, Verstegen's won that battle.
Third and one, Sun Prairie, I should say. We're down to the 13-yard line, and we are under 2 minutes. Both teams with two timeouts remaining. Florek, shotgun. Middleton fakes the blitz.
That was close.
Nobody flinched.
Really close.
I guess. Taylor. Denied. Ludwig was there first, and he forced him into Max Elliott for the tackle. Timeout. Fourth down. They wouldn't go for it, would they?
What? You know, I don't know what they would do. I would think at fourth and was it fourth and two? Fourth and three,
fourth,
maybe right
it's
now?
It's a long one. Yeah, it's fourth.
But
and
they got,
it's almost three, yeah.
They got a timeout to burn. They might try and drum off sides defensively. Hey,
oh,
sit tight. sit tight. Don't flinch on anything. Wait for the hard count.
Everybody in the joint knows you shouldn't jump.
Yeah, but that's easier said than done.
You never know.
Until you hear that hard count, you're like, oh.
Yeah.
And all you got to do is jump in the for encroachment. You don't have to touch anybody. As soon as you cross that plane, the flag goes up.
All right, they're going to call the timeout as the play clock ran down. A minute three is on the scoreboard clock. Let's see. From the 15, 22, 32 would be the field goal attempt for Oakley for a possible tie. There you see the Sun Prairie kicker warming up. I'm guessing that's what's going to happen.
I would think that's a smart play. Minute three left.
Yeah.
And then if they make that, kick it somewhere other than C.J. Furman.
Hey, good call. Here's the third down play. Oh, look at Ludwig.
Yeah.
Got
oh,
right
great
by
job.
The fullback. And,
yeah.
And Max Elliott with a sure tackle there.
Yeah, that's one where offensively you don't have the big pancake block. You need to engage and let your running back work off your backside. Wherever he's going, drive him that way, but let him work. Don't lunge and miss. Ludwig is too good of a player to do that to.
Well, here's your ball game. 32-yard field goal attempt by Alex Oakley. If he makes it, it's a tie game at 17. 1:03 left. Good snap, good hold. Oakley's kick is good. 32 yards for Alex Oakley, 17-17.
And you're talking very close to having C.J. Furmanek block that, coming off the right edge of that offensive line, the wing. Plants his foot, gets down the line. Oakley not phased, splits the upright, but a great effort by Furmanek. Watch on the right-hand side. Watch him plant his foot and get down the line.
Oh,
you're talking inches from being blocked.
He got around that edge, didn't he?
And great job by Oakley. It's hard. In college, it's hard to pros. You miss a field goal, and you know you booted it well, and you just push it wide right or left. To come back out in pressure time like this to tie up the game with less than a minute to play, that's huge on his part.
We've been doing this 10 years. I don't know that between us we've missed three games in those 10 years.
Yeah.
Have we ever had overtime?
I think we had one overtime.
On a game of the week?
It was a game. Yeah, I think we had one overtime. I'm trying to recall where it was.
I'm not remembering any overtime. Well, maybe I must have slept.
10 years is a long time.
Wait, no kidding.
Cheaper. I don't, you know, now you
say that. That's 90.
We've either had overtime or it's been darn close to, I don't know.
Well, we might have
our
chance.
We're
going to
look that up. Our statistician will look that up for us.
Oh, we have a statistician?
Well, we'll find one.
Uh-huh. Low budget, low overhead. Yeah. That's how we roll. 59 seconds left. There's Alex Oakley, who tied the game with a 32-yard field goal. Don't kick at the number 12. There you go. Little pooch punt. Hey, that's a live ball, kids. Fall on it. There you go. Austin Granderson sets Middleton up right at the 30-yard line.
Yeah, that's a little touch and go. You can see the Middleton players. Who's going to take it? Who's got it? Because nobody was communicating about that. Something like that. You just have to take the bull by the horns, yell it out. Mm-hmm. I got it. Me. Whatever you guys yell.
Yep.
And then cover down. And thankfully for them, Sun Prairie was bearing down. They were about 5 yards away from that ball before it was covered up. Huge stand here now defensively for the Sun Prairie defense. Can they bow up? Can they keep everything in front? Nothing deep and behind. Defensive backs, deep is the deepest, wide is the widest. Linebackers, get your sink, but keep feet moving because you're going to have crossers coming at you.
Davis Rocket continues to be the Middleton quarterback. He's going to throw. Sliding catch made right at the first down stick. 17, Jack Smith in to make the catch. First down.
Linebackers have to keep their feet moving. That time, Will Van Peterson got caught a little flat-footed. Continue to move, head on a swivel. Understand where guys are coming at behind you.
First and 10 at the 40. Rocket throws to nowhere.
I think
Jack
everybody's
Smith,
covered.
Yep, Jack Smith went up. Ball went out.
Everybody was covered. Smart play. Get it out of bounds. Kill the clock. Nothing hurt.
Joe Polisek, the Middleton field goal kicker, is converted from 22 yards out tonight. Also has a couple of extra points. But they need to get a whole bunch of yards before they start thinking field goal. 41 seconds left.
Find a way to make a play. Either side, find a way to make a play.
penalty marker.
Offside Sun Prairie.
No, oh, well, they're saying motion.
All right. Maybe that's what drew him offside.
False start. Yeah, maybe. Ooh, that hurts.
Yeah, it does.
Oof.
I saw the right tackle, defensive tackle flinch. I thought he was offside, but apparently drawn off.
So second and 15 it'll be.
Officials have done a good job here tonight, calling what they need to, but letting the guys play.
We've had one turnover, a fumble.
I think so. That was
by
it.
Middleton.
Yeah. A couple close interceptions, but.
Well, he's two solid teams, aren't they? Furmanek now at quarterback.
Sure.
Oh, he's going to try and do something with his feet. Look at him go. Furmanek with a big run. Oh, lost the football, but he was down.
Well, he took a pretty good lick there, too,
sure
at the
did.
End. Marty Stry. I think it might have been number 80 out there as well, and that's Andre Kleesner.
Mm-hmm.
Andrew Kleesner, excuse me.
Yep. Yeah, Furmanek with just a little hitch in his giddy up there, it looks like. He took a pretty good hit. Timeout Middleton. They have one left. 31 seconds left.
Well, that ought to tip the defense now. If he's coming back in there, watch for some quarterback keeper, quarterback draw, getting guys, pushing them upfield, and then engaging down the field. Again, Marty Stry coming up, Kleesner coming up. Too many guys flying by. You got to pad your feet, break down, keep them inside in front, certainly keep him in bounds. And here he's sitting third and short. This could be a really big play for Middleton. Sun Prairie's got to watch for that 10 to 15 yard drag across the middle, not to give up something as guys are streaming down the sidelines. First things first for Middleton, get the first down. Find a way to get the first down.
Yep.
They'll probably spread that defense out, kind of create some seams in the middle. Permanent comes back in, watch for that same type of play, or maybe a little hesitation step up. He drops back to throw the football.
By the way, officially they're making the Oakley field goal from 33 yards, not 32. That tied the game. Here we go. Third and two, Middleton. Handoff. Stopped in the backfield. David Bryan, 55.
Bryan and Josh Dinga, two guys finishing them off together. Dinga's at right tackle. Bryan's the left tackle. You got Chestnut in the middle. Both those guys split the seams. Outstanding job of getting back there. That's going to put this game.
Wow.
Well, they're calling timeout. No, I thought they might have let it down.
Oh, and I'll tell you what.
4 seconds.
He darn near lost
he
that
did.
Football.
He was very lucky. And with a lot of white jerseys streaming up field, that could have been a fumble recovery for six. They might go for one Hail Mary here, maybe.
Ooh. Get a pass interference, maybe?
Something.
Well, here's the situation. Fourth down and seven, Middleton. Ball's at their own 44. Timeouts. Middleton used their last. Sun Prairie has one left.
They got nothing to lose, I guess, other than interception for return. But in a game like this, a rivalry game with these two teams, we've seen a fake punt early in the game at the 50-yard line. I don't know. What the heck? Give it a shot.
Right.
The old victory defense, we've seen that go for and against teams many, many times.
Mm.
You got to stand up. You're excited.
I'm all jittery. This is great. Sun Prairie has four punt receivers at about their 20-yard line. Defenders.
Yep.
Four defenders back at their 20-yard line. The prevent defense is in effect.
Looks like Rocket's back in the QB.
Yes, he is. Number 8, Rocket. Here we go. As a man, Ashford caught it down, and time's run out here in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, pad the stats.
Yeah. Yeah, Ashford's big night. But he's tackled at about the 32, and we are headed to
our first overtime. Or maybe second.
No, we got to remember what the rules are and everything. How about that?
What a great game. To have that flurry of points scored back and forth like that was exciting. with a kick return, and then you got a guy that missed a field goal to tie it up, comes back, gets a second chance at it, is able to do that. And Alex Oakley, and then Middleton has one last chance. They're sitting at a third and short, and a great defensive play by Sun Prairie. So just a lot going on between these two teams, back and forth. Some really good football and some breaks by both sides as well that they took advantage of. And that's a sign of a good football team, good football game. And I think two teams that we've seen here tonight, Jay, that are pretty well coached. And the guys that understand the rivalry between these two, that you never give up until that last second is ticked off the clock. Now they get a chance to go at it again. Pretty exciting.
Yep. Middleton took a 3-0 lead back at 1:27 of the first quarter. Nathan Florek hit Walker Jenkins with a 56-yard touchdown pass. It was 7-3, 7 seconds left in the first quarter. Deion Huff, a 1-yard touchdown run, put Middleton up 10-7. Then Florek hit Nate Verstegen with a 4-yard touchdown to make it 14-10 Sun Prairie. C.J. Firmenich took the next kickoff back 91 yards for a touchdown. 17-14 Middleton with 5:17 left. And then Alex Oakley with a 33-yard field goal with 59 seconds left in regulation to tie it at 17. All right, if you're in overtime, you want the ball first, you want to defend first. You'd want to defend first, yeah. Right?
I would, but I'm a defensive guy.
Well, that's true. I forgot that. Well, I walked right into that one, didn't I?
You know, I think there's a mindset that coaches, when they communicate with each other, that says, how are we doing either way? Is our offense hot? Is our defense hot? And what do we want to do? How do we want to position this with the guys? And for Sun Prairie getting a big stand there, if they win the toss that way and they decide to go on defense, yeah, you can knock it out and, hey, let's go. But if you get a stop, that's a huge boost for your offense to come out on the field. Even if you have to tie it up with a field goal, it's just a huge boost knowing that you gave it all you can and you either held the team to nothing or 3 points. And if you end up scoring,
look at Ben Hauser struggling to get out there, the captain. Oh, doggone it. Great competitor, but just can't go right now. Well, maybe he'll try and win the coin toss and help out, I guess.
Hey, whatever you got to do, right?
Captain's meeting the boy. You can see the respect there.
Oh, yeah. It's been a good ball game, hard fought. It's been tough. I mean, these guys are tired and exhausted. They're all hurting right now, and they got to find a way to dig for about another 10, 15 minutes.
And the biggest plays of the game are still to come.
Yeah, that's right. And we've seen some big ones. You talked about the scoring plays. We saw a number of times on third down, short, third and long, where both sides, the defense has made a stop. It's been really, really good that way. We've seen a lot of big plays that could have turned the tide in the game earlier with interceptions. Those were dropped. And we saw the fumble recovery that Sun Prairie got and how huge of a momentum boost that was for them. And then on the flip side, what a huge 91-yard kickoff return to bring the momentum back to your side that we saw to C.J. Firmenich and Middleton. Just a lot of big plays, a lot of opportunities. And here we sit with two very evenly matched teams with an even score right now heading to overtime.
Okay.
Good stuff.
Middleton has won the toss. Looks like they're going to go toward the goal line to camera left.
Looks like they're going on defense first.
Yeah,
from what
I think
they're
going
on
personnel. Yep. Yeah, that's where all the hats are going on. Well, the officials have done a great job.
Yeah, they have.
Great job tonight.
Well, it's been good. I think we've seen them communicate not only with the coaches, but more importantly the players on the field. What did I do? What did you call? So they understand what are we watching and how can we work against that to make sure we don't get a penalty.
Can I go on a limb in the second week of the season saying one of these teams will at least share the conference title?
I think you could. You go out on the limb first. Yeah. So I'll be right behind you.
Everybody in Verona and Jaysville and Blair are throwing stuff at their TVs now. But
that's the beauty of this conference, though, is we saw it last year.
Yeah.
I mean, Middleton had a share of it.
Right.
It came down I think Memorial beat him towards the tail end of last year.
Yep.
Sun Prairie was in the mix for a little bit, and then they stubbed their toe a couple times. But seven teams make the playoffs. Whether they lose or not in the first or second round, it doesn't matter. You got a conference that's putting teams in postseason. That's exciting stuff.
Here we go from the 25, a pump and go. Verstegen has a step. Verstegen caught it. Touchdown, Sun Prairie. Another strike from Nathan Florek to Nate Verstegen on the first play of overtime, and Sun Prairie's up 23-17.
So I'm going to change. I think I want to go on offense first. Wow.
Yeah.
Exciting, a little double move. Great protection up front first from that offensive line for Nathan Florek. Beautifully thrown football. A little bit of a push off just at the tail end by Verstegen, but not enough to warrant a penalty. And again, strong going after the football, securing it, coming up with the biggest play of his career.
23-17, the extra point attempt coming from Oakley. Oh, and Furmanek almost got that one. But he didn't, and it's good. 24-17, Middleton must score a touchdown from the 25-yard line to continue the game.
So both sides know exactly what they need to do. Obvious. Offense, you're coming out. Your defense just gave up a big play. Heads are hanging. You got to find a way to get the momentum. The defense for Sun Prairie coming out on the other side is excited. They're energetic. That drag of that final few minutes of that game is gone. They are fired up. Now let's see what they can turn loose and get after Middleton here. But we've seen quick strike out of Middleton, too. It's I don't know what's in store here, but C.J. Furmanek looks like he's coming back out. So, again, a guy that can hurt you with your feet, not just his arm.
And how about we're going to go after C.J. Furmanek to get two touchdowns late in the game.
And a big third down pass on a slant by Verstegen, too.
And he's right there.
Right.
Great throw, great catch. Okay. Here's Furmanek, empty backfield. Timeout, Sun Prairie.
They're running a little jet sweep there.
Yeah, Dion Huff was coming around, but Sun Prairie called the timeout. Oh, man.
Can you imagine what's going through the coach's mind? How do we keep ourselves composed and contained so these kids don't freak out on us on the field? Because it's intense, right?
Well, and you know, and right now we don't know how much is on the line here, but I think we all know what's on the line here.
Yeah, whoever wins this game, I think you're right. They're going to go on and compete. You talk about the stretch that Middleton has towards the tail end. They got Verona at home, though. They have Parker at home.
Yeah.
Their last game is at home. Sun Prairie's got a little bit different where they got to go to Verona. Mm-hmm. And then they have, I think they end up going to Verona. Verona might be at home, but they got to go to La Follette the last game of the year. Just very, very difficult stretch for both these squads to run the gamut.
Yep. All right. Here we go after the timeout. First down. Furmanek keeping. Furmanek still going. That's a good gain for Furmanek. I think that's a first down. Yep, inside the 15.
That's what he heard him on towards the tail end of regulation. They did a good job of faking that jet sweep, getting everybody kind of take that step to the left. Step to the left defensively. He splits right up the middle.
It's at the 14-yard line, so it's a first down. 10 yards to go for Middleton. Again, in overtime, you start your possession at the 25, and then it's just like a regular play where 10 yards gets you a first down. Huff in motion again. Furmanek to the end zone, tipped and incomplete. That's that guy, Travis Wallace, 26? No, 29.
That's Chestnut, wasn't it? Was it 26?
Yeah, I think it's 26.
There's 29 there. Oh, 20, it is 26. Yep.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I thought it was Chestnut, too. Yeah. He's been there all night. But I think that's 26, Travis Wallace.
It is.
We'll get another look here.
Yeah, it is 26. Floating out from his linebacker position.
Wow, he got up.
Got some good vert there. Great job.
Second and 10, Middleton. They must score a touchdown.
Just do your job, nothing more.
Huff. Well, he got about three, and then he's dragged backwards.
Zach Perrichton on the mix. Whole bunch of other guys as well. Chestnut back in the mix.
Safe to say it's four down territory
sure
here.
Is. Yeah, you have to, without a doubt.
Captain Obvious. Yeah. It's to the 13. Make it the, they're saying the 13 on the scoreboard.
Looks
anyway,
like
it's third
12,
and eight.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd say third and eight of the 12. Furmanek brings them to the line. Huff is the single running back. Huff. not much there. It's going to be fourth and long for Middleton.
David Bryan, the left tackle, created surge. Linebackers flowing behind. And he's going over Lyles over on the right-hand side of that offensive line. Just a good, hard step. Sometimes you have this mystique of this big player that's going to the University of Wisconsin, and he's a talented player. There is no doubt about that. But sometimes that momentum, that energy, that adrenaline, that first hard step, when you blow by him and you get him to reach, now you've created space and trouble for guys to flow through.
We started this game just after 7 o'clock, and it's coming down to one final play.
Wow.
This has been something. You know, we all knew this was the game of the week, in southern Wisconsin. And a lot of times, last year it didn't live up
to
it.
Right.
This year.
It has, and then some.
And then some. All right. It's fourth and six from the 10-yard line. Middleton must get a first down at least. They must eventually score a touchdown to keep this game going. And if they score,
do it all over
one
again.
Or two. I don't know. First, they need to score.
Yeah. First things first, I would guess they'd play for the tie and line up and do it again.
All right. Here's the game.
Crowds up and into it. Mm-hmm.
Jack Smith is split far right. Ashford's to the left. Hellbach and Huff are to the left as well. They're going to the end zone for Ashford. He's got it. Touchdown, Middleton.
Wow. Well, let's sit down and do it again. Wow.
But they need
extra
the extra point.
Yeah.
Wow. Well, Firmenich just said, here you go, Mr.
It.
Ashford. Go get it. And he did. Myron Ashford.
Great effort going against Caden Kalpinen as a cornerback. Kalpinen, much like Firmenich with Verstegen, in good position to make a play. The offensive player just was more aggressive going after the football.
Bryce VanderSanden is the holder. Rocket is the holder. Here's the kick. Good! 24-24. Wow.
We've seen a lot of players making plays at huge, opportune times. Receivers and Verstegen. Outstanding. Going against Firmenich, who's had an outstanding game himself. And then you look at Kalpinen, who we just talked about, the cornerback. Really amazing when you look at Ashford. The effort that he made just slips underneath. Kalpinen just needs to flip his head around, locate the football, and he can knock it away. But the offensive players in front of him are shielding him. That's just really good football.
Yeah, Sun Prairie took the lead in overtime on a touchdown pass to Nate Verstegen, but then C.J. Firmenich to Myron Ashford answers from the 10-yard line, 24-24.
And in overtime, now they flip ends of the field. Middleton will go first. So that defense that just gave up a touchdown has to get back out there, regroup, and see what they can do to get a stop here. The offense has the momentum. They get a chance to go at it again. Just good stuff.
There's just a breath of wind. What little wind there is would be going to the right of your screen. So it would help in the direction that the offense is going here.
I'm looking at the other end where there's not any movement on the flag.
There's nothing there.
It's got to be pretty slight.
Now they're waiting over at the Good Neighbor Festival for us to
be done.
Get done. Some people will keep looking over there saying, they're still open, I guess. But we're not done yet. So Middleton gets the football to start the second overtime.
This is fun.
All right, C.J. Firmenich just, again, does a little bit of everything. And he put that pass right on target to Ashford for the tying touchdown in the first overtime. Second overtime, first and 10, Middleton from the 25. Penalty marker. Motion, Middleton.
Well, if they end up losing this game, that's going to be a storyline for Coach Simon to look at. Way too many penalties on this team. Stuff that should not happen. pre-snap that way. There's way too many yards that we gave up through the the ground with the yellow flag.
I know Coach Simon. He doesn't like penalties.
I know. I don't know many coaches that do.
No, bad ones.
Yeah, they don't last in that profession very long, do they?
So it's back at the 30. First and 15 for Middleton. Firmenich, complete. 88, Cole Perrell. Perrell with the reception.
Ackley and Stride, a couple names we've called a number of different times here tonight, in on the tackle. That's fine. Keep them inside, in front. Good yards after catch, they call it.
Good solid seven-yard gain. Second and eight, 22-yard line. Second overtime, Middleton. Oh, my gosh, another penalty marker against Middleton. Ooh, boy.
I didn't see that one. I was watching the receivers and everybody adjust, so I don't know who jumped, but.
Somebody's not going to like the film session on Monday, I'll tell you that. Back to the 27, second and 13 now.
Back and forth we go, right?
Yeah. Firmenich steps up, has a man, Ashford, near sideline and out of bounds. Boy, Myron Ashford makes another big reception. First down, Middleton.
Well, they got to get something on him to slow him down. He's getting off the line of scrimmage free, and he's getting a whole head of steam, pushing guys off. Got to find a way to slow him down at the point of attack. But good patience up front, good blocking up front. Firmenich delivering a perfect strike, and then Ashford being smart, getting extra yards, getting out of bounds.
They needed 13. They got 13. First and 10, Middleton, 15-yard line. Firmenich, end zone. Oh, boy, that was an interception chance for Caden Kalpinen. But it was just a little bit too far for him.
Looked like Will Van Peterson, inside linebacker. They had an outside backer over the top and let him run scot-free down the middle, but Van Peterson comes from the middle, forces some air underneath, and as you said, Kalpinen right there, he's probably a yard two away from making an interception and turnover for Sun Prairie. But overthrown for everybody, which is smart by CJ.
Second and 10, 15-yard line, Middleton. Firmenich keeps it. Firmenich to the 10, inside the 10. Stry helped on the tackle. Now check that, 31, it's Parrish, along with Ethan Ackley.
Firmenich gets up. He is not feeling good right now. He's limping. Third and four, big third down, obviously. But he is hurting. He's taking some shots tonight. Keeps coming back for more.
Middleton, third and four, 9-yard line, second overtime, tied 24-24. Timeout, Sun Prairie.
Yeah, when they went that bunch set, then they wanted to get a little bit more beef up front. That's just a good formation call by Middleton. They're trying different personnel in there and caught Sun Prairie a little bit backwards, and they needed to burn that timeout.
I tell you, the crowd has stuck around, too.
Sure has. Student section for Sun Prairie is across the way now, down on the far end, lining the track.
Yeah.
There you see Middleton's fans and their student section and band. Good stuff.
Look at that. That's the Middleton sideline. Yeah.
Good stuff.
Everybody's sticking around.
Why not?
Well, I'm not
I
sure.
I wouldn't leave.
And then look at that. They're ringing the track outside,
cool,
too.
That is cool.
I'm not even sure what a ticket costs, but it sure was a good value tonight.
$5?
Is it $5? That's a pretty good deal.
Yeah, you got to see one and a half games.
That knocks her down with.
Yeah, don't do math now.
Yeah. Yeah, I know. Okay. Here we go. Third and four, 9 yard line. Ludwig and Halbach in front of Huff. Huff gets it. Squirts through and stays on his feet to the five, and that's right where he needed to get. And it's a first down, Middleton. Boy, how do you defend all that beef? Yeah. My gosh.
Great second effort by Huff, though, to get off to the right side. Not bad surge by Sun Prairie's defense. They got a body on him, but it wasn't squared up. He was able to get to the side and continue to move his feet. They get square on him. I don't know if he's able to fight for that first down, but because it came from the side and keep those legs moving, he's able to move the chains first and goal from the five.
First down and goal. Huff keeps the legs driving, keeps the pile moving. Touchdown, Middleton! That makes it 30-24. Middleton scores first in the second overtime.
Well, you've had time to sit and watch, time to rest up offensively. Come back and go at it, see if you can get an answer just like Middleton did the last time in the first overtime period. And here you sit. Again, extra point has to be good here.
Polasek with an important extra point. It's good. 31-24, Middleton. Dion Huff with a 5-yard touchdown run.
Just a lot of surge off the left-hand side, like you had said. How do you stop all that? I don't know. But they got something stopped here, and then offensive linemen continue to drive in, push forward. Lyle's getting a little extra shove, and that pushes him over the goal line. Score the touchdown. Here Sun Prairie comes up offensively. What can they dial up to get an answer?
So here comes Sun Prairie. Nathan Florek has 3 touchdown passes so far tonight. I'm guessing he thought for all the world that last one won it.
Yeah.
But Middleton responds.
There's a lot of people thought that.
Yeah, yeah. This is a give to Jalen Taylor. And Taylor, just as soon as he gets the ball, is tackled for a gain of about 1.5 yards. Joe Ludwig leads the tacklers for Middleton. Sun Prairie trails by 7. It's 2nd and 8 at the 23. Second overtime. Florek complete. That's Jenkins.
This about is 3 or 4 yards short here now.
They're going to spot it. Boy, all the way down to the 17, 18.
Just 3 and 4 on the board. Yeah, 18-yard line.
3rd and 4. Florek, Taylor, bounces it outside and can get nowhere. Jack Smith, 17.
That's
CJ Firmenich was there,
yeah,
too.
Really good job defensively holding the ground. That's one where Taylor, if he looks, he started to engage and push that angle towards the defenders. If he bellies to the outside a little bit, he creates some space, gets out in the open where defenders have to get off blocking. Maybe is able to turn the corner, but really good job holding the edge by the Middleton defense.
4th and 1 for Sun Prairie at the 16. They must convert to keep the game going.
They bring back in Draven Peoples and Deloney, the big fullback.
Peoples pushes forward, bounces outside. 5, touchdown, Sun Prairie!
Wow. Are you kidding me?
Draven Peoples playing on a gimpy ankle.
4th and 1.
Oh, my gosh, he scored.
Wow.
From 19 yards out, it looked like they had him stopped. And now you see that he must have re-injured or retweaked at least that ankle. He's now being helped off the field. But Draven Peoples made the big play as he scores. And Sun Prairie's an extra point away from forcing a 3rd overtime.
What great effort. Great blocking up front. And he sees something off to the left. Cuts hard. He pushes downfield. Gets hit. He's able to drag the defender in for the touchdown. Here comes the extra point.
Lane Gugger holds. Oh, and Furman again nearly got there to block it, which would have ended the game. But it's 31-31. All right, we've been doing this 10 years. Yeah. I know we haven't had three overtimes.
Oh, wow. This makes up for all the other ones it could have been.
Game of
Watch
the week.
Off the left-hand side here, though.
Yeah.
Peoples gets up there. He sees
something. Oh, look at the big fullback, too. Yep. He blocked up a guy.
He runs up there but sees that seam off the left. He's limping already. And right now he feels contact coming. He's got a few extra yards. It stretches out. A great job by Peoples of reading and recognizing and not being denied six points. But you're right. I think a huge block goes out to DeMarcus Deloney. Pushing back. If he doesn't do that, that play is stopped.
And I think Furmanek tried to make that tackle at the last 5 yards on Peoples, and he might have fallen on that ankle that's been hurting Draven. But boy, what a gutty run by.
That's
adrenaline
takes over.
Yeah.
When you know you're hurt, but you get in there. You don't feel that until the play is over. Wow.
We're going to take another look at the extra point that C.J. Furmanek, he's come so close all night. Watch how close from the on the right side. Number 12, Furmanek. Watch him dive and how close he comes. Oh, my God. That might have gone through his hands.
Yeah. Wow.
Okay.
What fun stuff.
Sun Prairie will get it to start the third overtime. Boy, this really pads your stats, too, doesn't it?
It does.
Offensively.
Yeah, it does.
From the 25, first and 10. Rushes on, and down goes the quarterback. Shane Bick with the sack for Middleton.
Well, he's come up with a couple of big defensive plays here tonight for the Cardinals of Middleton, and that one no bigger. Outstanding job of breaking through there, and running back has no chance, absolutely no chance, Jalen Taylor. You got to get down, you got to pad your feet, you got to at least slow him down, and he went right by him.
Loss of 9. It's second and 19 back at the 34. Oh, miscommunication, and Furmanek nearly intercepted it. Verstegen broke off the route. Florek threw it deep, and Furmanek nearly had a pick.
Just off his fingertips. That would have made up for all those extra touchdowns that he gave up. Great battle between him and Verstegen. Almost came up with a big play there.
Third down and 19 from the 34 for Sun Prairie. So do you get just enough yards to try a field goal? Do you go for the whole enchilada? Is it four down territory? Lots of decisions.
Yep. I think you're trying to get at least in field goal position here right now. Field goal or first down? They got twins on both sides, so they're going to go try and get something deep.
Yep. Throwing. Ball was tipped, I believe. Harrison Bielski putting pressure on Florek. Incomplete, fourth down.
Yeah, geez, now you take a look at this.
Oh, that's a 51-yard field goal. Yeah, that's a little hefty.
With the one that we saw that he missed, he's got the leg for it. But I don't know if you want to put that situation right now. I think you're just kind of looking to try and get some yards on a first down.
See number 13 there, top of your screen, right side?
Yep.
Throw it up high.
I got you.
Let the 6'6 guy go get it, huh? But you have to protect him long enough so he can do it. Florek, deep, incomplete. Middleton's defense holds, and now the Cardinals can win it with a score.
So now you're playing for field goal. If you can get a touchdown, great, but you're playing for at least a field goal right now, so that takes a little pressure off. Defensively, you got to come up and find a way to make a play like Shane Bick did on the first play from scrimmage for Middleton's defensive series. Mm-hmm. You got to find a way to make something happen. You got to create a turnover. Wow.
Well, if you're Middleton, I'd take all the guesswork out and get a touchdown, don't you?
Yeah.
Don't mess with a field goal unless you have to.
But you know you have that as your backup.
Right.
If you can get the touchdown, great. But that takes pressure off what you have to do here now. Obviously, you need to get a first down to get you in field goal position, really comfortable field goal
position. These guys have to be just gassed.
Oh, man,
oh, man. Here's Furmanek.
I'm tired.
Yeah. And you've just been talking. Furmanek at quarterback. He'll keep it. Oh, and he lost. Oh, he tried to pitch back at the last minute to Dion Huff. The ball was loose. They're still wrestling for it, but Huff hangs on. Wow.
Wow, lucky break there. And I think that was kind of by design. You'll see his running back kind of slip to the outside there. He's going to be there. Hey, I'm here. He knows that's a safety net, but that's just not a smart play by your senior quarterback. Go down. Don't even cough that up or have a chance to cough it up on the first play from scrimmage. That's just one. That's a learning point tomorrow in film as well. Go down, secure the football. We line up and play again.
Hackley and Chestnut both were grabbing Firmenich, and he almost lost the football. Almost turned it over, I should say. Second and 10 from the 25. Pass deflected. Josh Dinga makes the play.
Big guy to go through for that one. Dinga 6'4", and a defensive end that I've seen tonight a few times come off the edge with some purpose. But we talked about that. We saw Middleton knock down a pass. We've seen now some Prairie knock down a pass. If you can't get there, read his eyes, read his arm, be ready to make a play and get your hands up. He's coming off the edge, and he played a little tight end, I think, at different times for some Prairie. So he's looking to do the old J.J. Watt, catch it and score.
Oh, man, won't that be a way to end it? Third and 10 from the 25. They're going deep. Oh, and deflected at the last minute. They were looking for Jack Smith in the corner of the end zone. 47, Caden Kaupinen with a play. Fourth down.
And Kaupinen is who they beat the last time with Ashford deep into the end zone to answer some Prairie score. So he comes back. He learned. He found a way to get in position. Jumps at the last second to make the play. A great job by the junior defensive back, but a beautifully thrown football and a really good route as well by Smith. Just some good football across the board.
31-31.
Middleton timeout, it looks like.
Yep. Fourth and 10 at the 25-yard line. A field goal would be 42.
And you got 9 yards for a first down, it looks like, right?
Yep.
Huh.
This has been fantastic.
Wow.
I apologize if you're waiting to go somewhere when this game ends, but, I mean, this is...
Yeah, don't leave now.
This has been a classic. Both teams 1-0, winning their first weekend games. Both were ended early by bad weather last weekend.
I like watching stuff like this because there's a care factor to these kids. They don't want to give up. They will collapse on the field before they give up, and you love to see that heart, that grit, that effort by these guys here tonight. It's fun to watch young men kind of mature and grow and dig deeper than they ever thought they could.
Here we go, fourth and 10. Timeout.
Sun Prairie.
Well, both teams scored on their possessions in the first two overtimes. Middleton's defense stopped Sun Prairie's offense in their third overtime possession. We're at fourth and 10 from the 25 here in Middleton's third overtime possession. And if they don't score here,
we're going again.
We're going to overtime number four. And a reminder, next week, if this game ever ends, we'll be back here at Breitenbach Stadium for Monroe and Edgewood, Badger South Conference game. But first, we have to decide this one.
We might be here yet next Friday.
Yeah. We'll need a change of clothes, but there is that work thing we got to worry about, I guess. Huh. Fans are getting weary.
Yeah. Not sure how to react to all this, right?
That's right. Concession stand must be doing a great business tonight, I'll tell you that. Okay. Here comes fourth and 10 from Middleton. A score wins it. Firmenich. Incomplete. Threw it outside of Ashford. Sun Prairie's defense holds, and we will go to a fourth overtime.
They were just trying to get down and cover the first down. Well, we talked about it before with Ashford. They let him run off the line of scrimmage a couple of times, some big plays. That time they brought Kalpin in, who knocked up the play before. Then some Prairie comes back with the fumble recovery and back and forth. Then the kickoff return. And all of a sudden, when that started clicking, you started to see that confidence. And teams, both teams knew,
Yeah. Hey,
we can answer. They might break us down, but we can answer. And we've seen that carry over in here to overtime.
It's 10 o'clock.
Sweet.
3 hours have flown by. Middleton will get the ball to start the fourth overtime. I wonder what the record is for most overtimes in a
That's a great question.
I don't know.
I think now if they score touchdown, I think you got to go for two.
I think that's right. Yeah. Well, we'll find out.
Yep.
Okay, here we go. Middleton first and 10, 25-yard line. Fourth overtime. Firmenich rushes on, hit as he throws,
wow.
And still caught. I think that's Chris Olson, the tight end, and boy, Firmenich really took a hit. Now the receiver appears to be hurt or cramp or something. I think that's Chris Olson, 46.
I think you're right.
Yep, because 49 is Hellbach. Yep. Yeah.
First, a heck of a throw, going to get split right in half. Oh, as Firmenich throws this football. Coming off the edge, but an outstanding job of getting it up, just throwing it up and hoping his receiver can go get it.
Oh, man.
And then the wherewithal and the concentration for him to go, and that could have been grabbed by the back of the helmet. Official didn't call that.
Boy, Stryan, Parrott's really got Firmenich.
Yeah.
But you're right. And then the receiver went down awkwardly with that high tackle. It's a gain of two on the play. It'll be second and eight from the 23 for Middleton when play resumes here in the fourth overtime.
When that ball went up, I was thinking interception.
Yeah.
Just by the way, it was floating. It was coming short. But, again, a great job by that young man right there in Olson to concentrate, to go get the football, knowing he's going to get hit. Really good job.
Boy,
good to see him run off the field,
yeah.
Too.
Whoever wins this game, it's going to feel like two wins. 31-31.
Still going tight bunch formation.
Let's see if Huff gets the carry here. Second and eight. Sun Prairie jumped. Yep, offsides against Sun Prairie.
Well, that makes it second and three right now. That's a great job offensively just to sit, do the hard count. Yep. Knowing they're coming at you a little bit makes it much more manageable here now.
Encroachment costs them five. Second and three from the 18 now.
With Firmenich out there at quarterback, with this bunch, they've been going to Huff a bunch. Watch for him maybe to fake the handoff, curl out on his own, and just be a naked.
This is Huff. Tough yards on the inside. Still the pile goes forward to the 15 and just inside the 15. And it's a first down for Middleton. David Bryan on the tackle for Sun Prairie, but not before Huff gets the necessary yards for a Cardinals first down to the 15. First and 10.
Hey, you got to tighten up defensively here now. Try and get that surge. Try and reset the line of scrimmage, but hold your gaps. Hold the block and maintain.
Firmenich keeping. Stry tracks him down. Might have got a couple.
A lot of substitutions coming in and out for off defensive linemen trying to stay fresh and keep that burst going. Really good job. This offensive line for Middleton is big. They're strong. They're just trying to maul you down right now and let the skill guys behind them work off their back edge. So far, it's worked this series, and a good hard count on the penalty helped out. They're just trying to wear down that defensive front for Sun Prairie.
Second and eight. Fourth overtime. First possession. Huff got by the initial tackler. But then Sun Prairie's defense converges. Stry's in there, I see, getting up from the pile.
Digging deep. Both sides are digging deep.
God, this Marty Stry is a football player, isn't he? Good Lord, we've been saying his name all night.
Well, you talked about the one kid from Middleton, just his motor says go.
Yeah.
Marty Stry is the same way.
Yeah.
Same way. Just he does basketball as well, and I think you've called the game of the week with some Prairie a few times that way, and I've watched you call that.
Right.
Same thing. But these guys care, like you said. They want to win this. There's a care factor.
Third and five from the 10 for Middleton. Pitch to Hoff. Breaks one tackle, strings it outside, and he's going to get close to the five. I'm guessing he's going to be about a yard short, fourth down.
Looking from the official on the side coming in, it will be a yard short, fourth and one.
So, Chestnut, another tackle from Sun Prairie.
So here they go. Furmanek is coming out. They're not looking for
They're not looking at field goal, are they?
I watch for Furmanek to keep this thing. So be gap sound up front and hold the edge. Middleton, just get a body on a body and let him work.
It's been a night of critical plays, and here's another one. Fourth and one from the six. Sneak. I think he got it.
Not by much. They're just on the inside part of the five. You're talking a half a length of a football for a first down.
And that's all he needed. First down and goal now for Middleton just inside the five.
First and goal. That's fine. Defensively, you think, hey, line up and play again. Just keep, as long as we keep continuing to line up and play again, we're all right. Don't give up the little sneak.
Let's see if Huff gets another carry here. He's the deep setback. They'll pitch it. Right side. Huff scoots into the end zone. Touchdown, Middleton. Huff's second touchdown run of overtime. This one comes in the fourth OT. 37-31, Middleton.
And they do have to go for two, so they'll come back up and line up and play again.
Yeah.
Really like the effort pursued initially by that Sun Prairie defense, but the over-pursuit. Huff was able to get out there, plant, see a cutback lane, just go off the back edge of the wall that was built by that offensive lineman as two upbacks. He's able to pound his way in. Too many white jerseys off to the right side of that offensive line. They couldn't recover. Chestnut tried to, but too much momentum for Huff to carry him in the end zone.
And we have a timeout. Middleton.
Yeah, Tim Simon not happy with that at all. They had to call that because guys weren't ready to go or wrong personnel was in there. Just frustrating as a coach that way when you got the momentum and now you got to call it down and things calm down a bit.
Another look at Dion Huff's touchdown run that has put Middleton in front.
All leading to the right-hand side of this offensive line, and then he reads a good job, Marty Stry holding the edge. Right here is the cutback. Look at all the white jerseys to the right on the ground. Just way too many. You can't win a game when you're on the ground. You got to stay on your feet. Like I say, Kalpinen and Chestnut just a little too late to the party.
Well, I tell you, Joe Ludwig has made his name playing defense, but he's made some effective blocks in that big bunch formation that they have.
Well, and watching him do it, he's not afraid of contact, which is why they put him back there. I like to hit. Yeah, I'll go hit somebody for you, sure. If it helps us win and score, let's do it. Good-looking football player.
Yeah. So Middleton scores a touchdown in the fourth overtime. Sun Prairie will still get a crack on offense, whether the two-point conversion is successful or not. Well, and Middleton would love to go up eight here. And Sun Prairie, if they deny him, boy, they'd have new life and new energy. Furmanek will go out of the shotgun. Here comes Huff and the jet. Huff gets it. Huff stopped short at the five.
Chestnut and Van Petersen, we called them at all tonight?
A little bit.
Wow.
Wow.
That time they went with the little jet sweep, the handoff up front. Those two guys shed their block, got off it, and packed a punch.
So the good news for Middleton is they scored a touchdown and lead by six. The good news for Sun Prairie is it's still six. Boy, that's a great play by those defenders.
Sure was. Mm. That was actually 26. We got there wrong. Travis Wallace.
Yeah.
We're so used to saying 29.
Well, Wallace
with Chestnut, but that was Wallace. A
Wallace
big tip.
Knocked down that pass too earlier.
Coming in and playing. I don't know if he's substituted in for Ben Hauser, but he certainly made his name here in the last half of this. The last part of the fourth quarter in this overtime period.
Yeah. Well, the pressure's still on the Sun Prairie offense, but if they score and get a two-point conversion, they win it. First down carry. That is Jalen Taylor. Got about three or four. Got three. Second and seven. Sun Prairie has the football at the 22 as they have their offensive possession in overtime number four.
Let's go, defense!
Nathan Florek has taken over and thrown three touchdown passes. Here's Taylor trying to get to his right, but wrapped up. Jack Smith, I believe, got him around the ankles. Nope, check that. 47, Shane Bick. Bick's had a nice night, too.
Sure has.
All right. Third and five from the 20. Taylor again. Taylor bursting. Penalty marker down. Taylor into the end zone for a touchdown. And a second penalty marker at the goal line comes in. Oh, that's Peoples. Excuse me, Draven Peoples burst there. Boy, I guess his ankle's okay again, huh?
We'll see what the calls are here with both of them. They're pointing one way with one, but yeah, I don't know about the second one. I didn't see that.
I think it's going to go against both sides here. Both teams have pointed at the other. There you see all the yellow flags on the field.
Too much laundry.
Yeah, no kidding. Okay, it's a hold against Sun Prairie.
Or a block in the back, it looks like.
Or block
like.
In the back, excuse me.
Then holding. All right.
Also on Sun Prairie. So it'll be third down in a lot. So advantage
Boy,
Middleton.
That, yeah, no kidding. Well, we talked about the inopportune penalties for Middleton. Right. That's the biggest one right there for Sun Prairie that cost them the chance to tie and possibly win.
Right. Well, third and 13. So Sun Prairie will get two cracks at it to get 13 yards and stay alive. Florek, slant. Hey, Cooper Nelson with the reception. Proud papa here in the press box. That's
yeah,
good
but
play.
He's 2 yards short.
Well, he did gain
he
12.
Did. Yeah.
Fourth and one, Sun Prairie. That's kind of cool, isn't it?
It's really cool. Again, there's a care factor with these young guys. They get a chance to come in and make a play, and a nice throw by Nathan Florek. They tilted everybody with trips off to the other side, so it opened up where outside linebacker typically should have been. Yep. Good route, good throw, nice catch. Here he's sitting with fourth and two. A huge, huge play, and you're that close, and you realize how close you've been with interceptions. That penalty on the touchdown that Peoples just had, that gets called back. Just a great game back and forth, and you got one more chance. You got a chance to get a first down offensively, and you continue. You got a chance defensively to get a stop, and the game is over and you won it, and it's been an awesome evening here watching these two teams go at it. Just a lot of fun. A lot of names that we've never heard before have stepped in and made a lot of big plays for both sides.
Trey Turner made the tackle for Middleton. Cooper Nelson. So here come the Sun Prairie offense. Fourth and two, 17-yard line. Must convert to keep the game going. Peoples is the running back. Peoples has it, bounces outside. Penalty marker flies, and I think they're going to get Nate Verstegen for a hold.
Yep.
Peoples had the first down.
He gets up limping a little bit again. That's a second flag on Verstegen now that cost him. First hold with the block in the back or the hole, whichever it was, and the touchdown run, and now this one. Great job by Furmanek in forcing that situation where he's got to do something or draw the flag that way. Great job on his part to draw that flag.
Boy, and you could just see Verstegen after the flag was thrown.
Oh, he knew it.
Yep.
All right, that'll push Sun Prairie back one more time. There you see Peebles hobbling off. Ball's going to be spotted back at the 29. Fourth and about 15 for Sun Prairie. They must convert. Nathan Florek, the quarterback, trips right for Sun Prairie. Chases on. Hullback. Ball's in the air. Incomplete. And Middleton wins in four overtimes. Middleton 37, Sun Prairie 31, and as good a high school football game as you'll ever see.
Exciting on one sideline, just pain on the other, because you played so well back and forth. Players making plays, coaching making right calls, guys stepping up at opportune times, and you gave yourself a chance.
Yep.
Time and time again in regulation. He had a kicker that missed one and comes back to tie it up. Now you go into overtime, back and forth all the way through, and as hard as it is for Sun Prairie to take this one, they can do a lot of growing from this and understand how those flags really make a difference in the outcome of a game. Middleton overcame some of that adversity, and just a lot of fun to watch these two teams go at it here tonight. A really, really well-played ball game.
So Middleton goes to 2-0 in the Big 8. Sun Prairie drops to 1-1. Well, it's not the last we've heard from the Sun Prairie Cardinals this season, I can tell you that. But Middleton takes a huge step in this 2016 season. It took over 3 hours, about 3 hours and 15 minutes. And Middleton converts in overtime and holds Sun Prairie on fourth down. Well, Scott, welcome back to football.
Yeah, thanks. Wow, nothing better than this one.
All right, thanks for joining us. Great start to the 2016 season. Reminder that next Friday night we'll be back with you on the Prep Mania Game of the Week as we're right back here at Breitenbach Stadium as Monroe faces Edgewood. That'll be 7 o'clock next Friday night. For our entire Play on Sports Midwest crew, along with Scott Nelson, Jay Wilson, thanks to you all for joining us tonight. The final in four overtimes, Middleton 37, Sun Prairie 31. Good night from Breitenbach Stadium in Middleton.